back inside the Alex G. Spano Center, Zach Beirute alongside Coach T. Bob Thomason, so glad to have you with us. Pacific Tigers men's basketball on Fox Sports AM 1280. It's the Tigers and the St. Mary's Gales. Pacific coming in with a record of 13-4. St. Mary's coming in with a record of 14-2. We're a couple of minutes away from the national anthem and the team intro, so we're a little bit too early. This is the back end of a doubleheader. Congratulations to the Pacific women. They defeated Pepperdine just before we went on the air here. So the women played first, and here the men play the St. Mary's Gales. You know, in terms of playing a big opponent, I'll never forget watching you in a huddle before Pacific went to play Gonzaga. This is going back to 2012, I want to say. It was the year before Pacific joined the WCC. You huddled all the guys together, said, fellas, this is a great opportunity that lies in front of us. Now, Pacific went up to Spokane and lost, but I liked and I always remembered how you viewed that game as a great opportunity when you're playing a top-tier type team.
You want to have these opportunities, and you want to build on them so you can start winning those games. And then you become the team that everybody's getting ready for. And to do that, you got to win the home games. You know what I mean? Pacific's really had a lot of chances to beat St. Mary's at home, and they just haven't got it done. But now they're going to have to sometime break through. I mean, I can't believe the last time we won is when I coached down at Anaheim that day.
I remember that game.
It feels like I've watched a lot of games, and I go, they had chances to win. So. But hey, give St. Mary's a lot of credit, Randy Bennett. They've done a great job. They've been really consistent over the years, and he's done a terrific job.
We will keep it here for the national anthem and the pregame introductions. We're going to keep it here and keep our crowd mic on so you can kind of be with us for that. And after the national anthem and the introductions of both teams, we will have the starting lineups. This is a Klaus Endersat to. Yeah, we're okay. Klaus, you can chat with Coach T. Klaus is going to come over and chat with us when we're not live. But for now, the national anthem, and then we'll have the starting lineups, and we have the opening tip coming up in just a few moments. Let's stay here for the anthem and the team intros. Welcome back. Courtside to the Spano Center. You just heard the introductions of both teams. Zach Beirute alongside the great Bob Thomason. So glad to have you with us. The Pacific Tigers and the St. Mary's Gales from the Alex G. Spano Center. The lineups have been introduced to the crowd here at the Spano Center. And right now the teams are huddled together and they are getting ready to hit the floor. Trying to see, they don't have the starting lineups up quite yet on the live stats, which is where we usually get them. So I don't want to misspeak and give you the wrong names. I will tell you, the Tigers are wearing their home white uniforms. The Tigers wearing the home whites, white jerseys, Pacific green and black, block letters outlined in orange across the chest. A black number outlined in orange on the front and back of the jersey. The last name of each Pacific player written in black block lettering above the numeral on the back of the jersey. White shorts with black trim down the side. St. Mary's wearing their traveling navy blue jerseys. The blue jersey top has St. Mary's written in red block letters outlined in white across the chest. A red numeral outlined in white on the front and the back of the jersey. The last name of each Gale player is not on the jersey, but rather the main logo, the interlocking letters SMC with the G in the middle of the M is above the numeral on the back of the jersey. Blue shorts, red and white trim down the side for St. Mary's. For the Gales, here we go, it will be Tanner Krebs, Jordan Ford, Tommy Cousy, Dan Fotu, and Malik Fitz. So again, it's Ford, Cousy, Fotu, Krebs, and Fitz for St. Mary's. Pacific Tigers, it's Danis Jenkins, Brock Finstoon, Amari McCray, Jaleel Tripp, and Pierre Crockrell. Again, Finstoon, Jenkins, Tripp, Crockrell, and McCray for Pacific. Amari McCray will handle the opening tip, the 6'9" junior for Pacific, and for St. Mary's, the 6'7" sophomore from Auckland, New Zealand, Dan Fotu. Thank you. We should be about ready to go. I'm not sure the delay. And now we're good to go. Fotsu and McCray, the tip is up. It is controlled by nobody. It goes out of bounds on the far sideline, and it'll say off of Pacific. So St. Mary's will have the opening possession. And St. Mary's will move from our left to our right, from our vantage point on the far right side of press row, next to the Pacific bench. Is the inbound to Jordan Ford, and a whistle stops play as the shot clock never started. So we have multiple false starts here.
This happened this year.
This happened quite a bit. So the shot clock is now good to go, you would think. 26 seconds is ticking now as the shot clock is ticking away, as it should. Ford on the right wing. Ford up top to Fitz. Sling it to the left side to Krebs, and now Kuzi on the left angle. Enter it left of the lane to Dan Fotsu. Back out to Kuzi, top of the circle, guarded tightly by Crockrell. Kuzi dribbles toward the baseline, gives to Fotsu in the lane. He puts up a running right-hand shot that's no good. And Amari McCray clamps the rebound, gives to Crockrell, and the Tigers moving from our right to our left as Finstoon on the left wing has the ball knocked away by Fitz and stolen. Fitz has a player off to his left. It'll take it himself around Jaleel Tripp. He misses the layup. The ball is loose and finally gathered in by Brock Finstoon.
Now, that was a good power layup. He just laid it up a little too hard.
Finstoon up top to Jaleel Tripp. Tripp to his right to Crockrell on the right wing. Bounce pass baseline right to McCray. Amari backing his way in on Fotsu. McCray going to try and curl into the lane. He is stripped and stolen by Kuzi. Kuzi with a three-on-one gives to Fitz off to his right and a finger roll up and in, and that's how the scoring starts tonight.
Well, they've gotten two steals in the first three possessions.
Crockrell across the center court stripe. Pierre on the left wing will hand to Danis Jenkins up top to Brock Finstoon. Finstoon dribbles one time, then terminates and gives to his left to McCray. Amari hands it off to Crockrell, dribbling to his left. Crockrell explodes toward the baseline, takes a fadeaway over Kuzi and knocks
tough
it down.
Tough shot, he made that first one. That'll help him settle down.
2-2, so the team's exchanging baskets with 18:24 and counting to go in the first half as we're just underway from the Spano Center. Kuzi to his left to Ford. Ford dribbling to his left. We'll give it up top to Kuzi, and now on the right wing to Fitz. Fitz holding over his head, guarded by Crockrell, dribbles to his left, curls into the key, now into the lane, and he missed a dunk, but he got fouled. He beat Crockrell off the dribble. I think Pierre stumbled or slipped.
Well, Crockrell switched, you know, and they wanted to switch back, and he couldn't, and he just, you know, Fitz just said, I'm going to go take it to the hole because I'm 6'6", 6'7". He can't stop me. He went right around him, and then he got fouled with a dunk.
So Malik Fitz is at the line. Fitz is a 79% free throw shooter.
He's a heck of a player.
Free throw is up and good. It rattles in. Fitz, to Coach Thomason's point, averaging 16.5 points a game, just under 8 rebounds. A redshirt junior transferred from South Florida. This one is up and good, so he makes them both. 4-2, St. Mary's ticking toward 18 minutes and counting to go in the first half from the Spano Center. As up top, it's Finstoon, gives to his left to Crockrell. Pierre back to the right wing to Finstoon. Open three, but he dribbles to his right, passing it up, goes into the lane, leans in, it's no good. Tries to tip back his own miss, can't, but he gets his own miss, and for a third time trying to go up, has the ball knocked loose, no whistle. McCray scrapping for it on the ground. Amari trying to save it to Crockrell, he does, and Pierre backs out. There was a 20-second reset on the shot clock, so 13 on the clock right now. Crockrell navigating to his right, goes down right of the lane, bumps into Kuzi and kisses it off the window.
He pushed off a little right there, but he created space, and that was a good shot.
4-4, 17-28, and counting to go in the opening stanza from Pacific. As Fotsu is in the key, he's going to give it out to Kuzi. Shot fake, Kuzi dribbling to his right. Kuzi drives right of the lane, tries to sling it along the far side. Knocked out of bounds on the end line by Pacific. It'll stay with St. Mary's, 14 seconds on the shot clock. Looks like St. Mary's going to get a sub in right now, and it will be Krister Zorkis. Zorkis, a redshirt sophomore from Latvia, and he takes over for Tommy Kuzi. Zorkis inbounds to Ford, right corner. Ford dribbles with his left hand to his left. He's on the right angle, 10 on the shot clock. Spins it to his right, guarded tightly by Jenkins. Good defense. Gives it out to Fitz on the right wing. 5 to shoot. Fitz spins in the lane. Fitz trying to go over the defense. It wasn't there. Gives it out far side for a three at the horn, and that is Zorix who knocks it down.
I don't think you can let them kick the ball out for a shot. You're going to make the guy with the ball shoot the ball. Stay out there with those shooters.
Zorix is now 12 of 20 from beyond the arc this season. So that's over 60% from beyond the arc. Dribbling to his right is Crockrell. Tried to get to Jenkins. Too much on the pass. Goes out of bounds on the far sideline.
Pass behind him. He's curling off that screen. You got to throw it to him in the pocket.
From our left to our right, Jordan Ford will take it across the PowerCat logo and into the front court. Shaquilo Fritz has gone to the scorer's table for the Tigers as we tick towards 16 and a half minutes to go in the first half. Ford dribbling to his right. He's on the right wing. He's going to try and penetrate. Instead, gives to Fitz, who gives it up top to Krebs. Krebs driving left of the lane, stops near the left elbow, puts up a tough fadeaway, and knocks it down.
He's a good player. Got good skill to shoot the ball, pass the ball.
Krebs, a redshirt senior from Tasmania, Australia. He averages just over 10 and a half points a game. 9-4 St. Mary's. Finstoon up top, gives to his right to Crockrell. Crockrell drives toward the baseline, spins it back. Pierre near the right elbow will navigate back out. Now slip a bounce pass to McCray. Amari backing his way in, goes up over the defense. Left-hand shot that contested, no good, but Tripp, I believe, had the tip back.
Great tip in.
And they will indeed give Jaleel Tripp credit for the tip back. Ford in the front court, St. Mary's 9 and Pacific 6 is on the right wing. It is Zorix. Zorix up top to Ford. Ford off a screen, dribbles to his left. Ford from the left wing drives it in, tries to scoop it up, and goes out of bounds, they say, off of his knee. It was blocked back, and the ball ricocheted off his knee and out of bounds.
Good defense for the Tigers.
So it'll be Tiger basketball when we come back after a timeout on the floor from the Spano Center. This timeout comes with 15:39 to go in the first half. The St. Mary's Gales 9, the Pacific Tigers 6. We're back after this on Fox Sports, AM 1280. 15:39 to go in the first half. Zach Bayrudy, Coach T, Bob Thomason, glad to have you with us. St. Mary's 9 and Pacific 6. What can you glean from the first 4 minutes and 20 seconds?
Well, the Tigers have 3 turnovers, so at one they just took away from them. They over-dribbled the post. So the first 5 minutes of the game, you might have a little nerve, so maybe they can get over that. I think with McCray inside, they're playing him to drive to his towards the middle with his left hand. They're bumping him a little, but he's forcing his way. He's taking extra dribbles, and then they're going to help off the dribble. He's knocked a couple away, so they got to be careful of that.
Checking in on the early numbers, both teams pretty much even. Steven, St. Mary's 3 of 5 from the floor, Pacific 3 of 6. The Gales 1 of 1 from beyond the arc. The Tigers have not attempted a three-pointer or a free throw to this point.
Well, but the Tigers have 3 offensive rebounds, which has helped them since they've turned it over 3 times.
Nice crowd filing in here to the Spano Center. Nice to see that Stockton has come out in support of this team and realizing this is a very big game for this team. As up top, it's Danis Jenkins dribbling to his right. Jenkins pulls it up from 16 and knocks it down. Near the right elbow.
Very good off the dribble.
Jenkins near the right elbow, able to knock it in. And he gets Pacific to within 1, 9-8, St. Mary's. Swinging around to the left side, this is Fitz. Fitz up top to Fotu. Fotu is going to dribble to his left, handed off to Ford, who curls the dribble to his right. He stops at the top of the circle, gives to Zorix, and now back up top to Ford with 11 on the shot clock. Ford guarded by Jenkins, dribbling to his left. Ford slings it back up top. This is Zorix going to drive it in, then kick it back out to Ford with 2 to shoot. He launches a desperation 3, and it's off the front of the rim, and Shaquilo Fritz, having checked in at the media timeout, comes away with the rebound. Also, Austin Vereen on the floor checking in. Tripp's going to take it to the 10, put it off the glass.
Oh, my goodness. That was a man move right there.
And the Tigers have their first lead of the night. It's 10-9 Pacific. Jaleel Tripp, you said it, Coach. That was an explosive move to the bucket. Nobody was going to stop him. And if they were, it was going to be a foul. He got a quick first step. Dribbling to his right is Fotu. Hands it off to Zorix. Zorix up top to Fitz, and now on the left wing to Ford. Ford up top to Krebs. He's dribbling to his left. Krebs trying to go down left of the lane. They're going to call Austin Vereen, I believe, for an armbar foul, and they will. So they say Vereen got into him a little bit extra. 7 seconds on the shot clock at the time of the foul. It'll be a 20-second reset to the shot clock. I think they're saying that Vereen got his left hand underneath the arms of Krebs, and you can see it on the replay.
Yeah, I mean, St. Mary's doing a good job forcing the contact with the drives, you know, and you just got to beat him to the spot.
Kuzi's back on the floor. Kuzi gives to Krebs on the left wing. Krebs holding over his head, back up top to Kuzi, guarded by Crockrell. Kuzi off the screen, dribbles to his right. Kuzi slings it back to his left to Krebs. He takes a left wing 3, and that's off the mark. Rebound going to be taken by Fitz. It was loose for a moment. It was not a bad attempt there by Fritz to get the rebound. Nice attempt by Fotu as well to jar it loose. And St. Mary's comes away with the rebound. So second chance opportunity, 8 on the shot clock. Fitz a right wing 3. That's no good. And the rebound taken by Pierre Crockrell. Our right to our left. He's in the front court. Crockrell dribbling with his left hand, switches to his right, goes to the right wing, chest pass up top to Vereen, now to the left wing to Tripp. Jaleel asking for a screen. Vereen gives it. Tripp uses it to his right, gives it near the high front court to Crockrell. 13 on the shot clock. Pierre hands it off to Jenkins. Up top to Tripp. Jaleel dribbles to his right. Tripp crosses over, goes right down the right of the lane. Nice shot fake, and he kisses it off the glass and in.
Yeah. Lots of times they called traveling there, but it wasn't. His back step moved once. I'm glad the referees had a little patience right there.
Tigers on a nice little run right now. And it is a 12-9 Pacific lead as Cousy gives a bounce pass
that's
in the lane
the
to Fotu and
do.
He lays it up and
make
in.
Him shoot the ball. Make the passer shoot that shot. Don't have two people on him and give him an easy layup.
Jenkins to Vereen up top. Vereen dribbles to his right, now gives to Crockrell right corner. Pierre dribbles with his left hand around to his left. He's on the right wing. Crockrell guarded by Cousy. St. Mary's in man-to-man. Crockrell up top gives a bounce pass left elbow to Fritz, and he gives it back to Pierre, who drives toward the baseline. Cousy knocks it away. It goes out of bounds. Last touched by Cousy in St. Mary's. Cousy is down right now. I think he got hit in the face, and they might have something to look at here on a replay. It was inadvertent. It was just the hands going for the ball, but Cousy right now is down on his stomach on the end line.
Yeah, they just bumped heads. There wasn't anything the Tigers did. If anything, it should be a foul on Cousy, you know, for leaning in on defense.
So, again, to give you the situation, it's Pacific ball. That's the call on the floor. 9 seconds on the shot clock. And if there's any kind of contact to the head area or the face that they deem was not incidental contact, they might assess a foul to, I think it was Crockrell who got him, I think.
I think they got each other. I mean, Crockrell didn't do anything.
He
leaned in, Crockrell was right there, and they both kind of bumped heads. And maybe Cockrell's head's a little harder than Kuzman, so he backed off.
Tommy Cousy, by the way, spells his name K-U-H-S-E. His family grew up St. Mary's fans. He's from Mesa, Arizona, but they grew up big St. Mary's Gales fans. So he spells his last name differently than Bob, Bob Cousy. He's from my hometown of Worcester, Massachusetts, by the way. One of the all-time great Worcester, Massachusetts residents, Bob Cousy, all-time Celtic great. Officials are convening right now. Looks like there's nothing there. Yeah, it was Crockrell who had the contact. Yeah, you're right, Coach. They bumped heads. That was a scary play right now.
If they were to call something on that, I'd give up.
Yeah, I couldn't tell if it was, from our angle, if it was a hand or a head, but it was a head.
Hey, 9 on the shot clock.
Jabril Price-Noel checks in, as does Gary Chavichian. Also out there, Fritz, Vereen, and Tripp for Pacific. Price-Noel will be the one to trigger in. Baseline left. And Price-Noel will inbound to Chavichian for a left corner 3, and
yeah,
it is no good,
foul.
But he traveled. You saw him take a step, so he received
the ball.
He caught
it and then put both feet rather than, you know, when the ball's in the air, you plant one foot, and he kind of caught it and took a step, you know.
So traveling violation gives the ball back to St. Mary's. Pacific 12, St. Mary's 11 is Ford on the left wing, dribbling to his right off a screen set by Jock Perry, who's out there for the first time. Now on the right wing, it's Zorix. Zorix dribbling to his left, slings it back to his right to Fitz. Fake right, dribble left for Fitz. Drives in right of the lane. Good shot fake. Puts it up. Fritz partially blocked it. Jock Perry gets the rebound, puts it up, and that's blocked by, I believe, Shaquilo again. Trip along the far right sideline. And in rhythm, transition 3, and it's short. That's really not his shot. And a rebound taken by Fitz.
And when you're 1-for-23, I don't know if you should be shooting that shot off the dribble, but he's feeling it.
Ford will spin the dribble back. He's beyond the right wing, gives it to his left, and now swing it around to the far left side to Krebs. Krebs holding over his head, and then he enters or tries to Perry. It's knocked away by Shaquilo Fritz. And St. Mary's will retain possession with 10 seconds on the shot clock. Jaleel is now 1-for-24 from beyond the arc after that missed three-pointer. I'll give him this. He was open for it, but really not the shot you wanted to take.
You'll give him being open? He should be open. I wouldn't even guard him out there.
I would sag to 15 feet on him.
I'd want him to shoot that shot because he's so tough.
For sure.
He's so tough going to the basket. So especially early in the shot clock. Now, that was 7 seconds in the shot clock. I think he should take that shot. But other than that, I don't think he should be doing that right now.
All right, I've been put in my place by Coach C.
I don't know about that, but you go, well, he was open. I mean, you know why he's open?
I do. We'll take a timeout. It comes with 11:46 to go in the first half. It's Pacific 12, St. Mary's 11 on Fox Sports AM 1280.
What presents NFL 100. Remembering a century of excellence in pro football, sponsored by Prevagen. Prevagen is the most recommended memory support brand by pharmacists. In the final game of the 1982 season, Dallas Cowboys running back and future Hall of Famer Tony Dorsett created his own Monday Night Football magic against the Minnesota Vikings. Backed up on their own one-yard line, Dorsett took the handoff from Danny White and ran his way into the NFL record book.
Here is the give to Dorsett. He breaks through a hole and comes out to the 10 to the 15. He may run 99 yards. Here's to midfield. He's to the 40, 35, 30, 25, out of bounds. No, he didn't go out of bounds. It's a touchdown. A touchdown for Tony Dorsett, the longest rush from scrimmage in the history of pro football.
Dorsett's 99-yard run stood alone in the history books until Derrick Henry of the Tennessee Titans tied the mark last year. Stay with Westwood One all season long as we celebrate the 100th season of the National Football League.
Fox Sports AM 1280. The Central Valley Sports Station.
.11:46 to go in the first half. Zach Beirute, Coach T, Bob Thomason, glad to have you with us. Pacific 12, St. Mary's 11. And it's St. Mary's ball with 10 seconds on the shot clock. Our officials, by the way, today, we failed to mention Nate Harris, Klaus Endersat, and Travis Schatzman. Failed to mention the officiating crew at the top of the broadcast. It's going to be inbounded and then flung into the backcourt, or the high front court, I should say, where it's received by Jordan Ford. It was a long-distance inbound pass. Up top to Fitz. Fitz dribbles to his left, spins at the free throw line, takes a tough fadeaway,
and
knocks it down.
You know, that's a tough shot, spinning, jump shot. You can live with those shots. They're doing a great job. They're doing especially a good job on Ford. They really have done a great job in the off-ball screen with him.
Vereen up top to Chavici and back to Vereen on the right wing. Austin dribbles off a screen to his left. He takes a 16-foot pull-up in the key. It's no good. The rebound is loose, and it's controlled by Jock Perry. He shovels it to Krister Zorix, who takes it into the front court. Zorix is going to drive into the free throw line, try and give it across the way to Perry, and Perry fumbles it away to Vereen. So St. Mary's turns it over. Our right to our left, Price Noel on the left wing. Jabril slings it up top to Tripp. Now to the right wing to Vereen. Vereen, chest pass up top to Price Noel. Jabril dribbles and hands it to Vereen up top to Chavichian. 15 on the shot clock. Chavichian over the head pass to Price Noel, who dribbles to his right. He's at the top of the circle, gets a screen, continues to his right, probes in, takes a leaner and knocks it down.
Tough shot right there. His offense getting better and better. I thought he was big in that Pepperdine game, hitting those couple threes.
10:37 and counting to go in the first half. Pacific 14, St. Mary's 13, as these teams leapfrogging each other now. On the right wing, it's Zorix, gives to his left to Perry. He gets it down low to Fitz. Fitz backing his way in on Chavici and up with the right hand, and it's no good, and Jahlil Tripp, Johnny on the spot for the rebound. Our right to our left, Tripp across the center court stripe. He's on the left wing. Jahlil uses a Fritz screen, passes to his right to Price Noel. Price Noel dribbles toward the far sideline, gives to Chavici and a long three. It's too strong, and the rebound taken by Jock Perry. That was way out there, but he can make that shot. He had some separation. Ford up top, dribbles toward the right elbow, kicks it to the right corner. This is to Alex Dukas, who has just checked in for the first time, a freshman from Australia. So Dukas in for the first time for St. Mary's. It's in the hands now of Zorix. At the top of the circle, Zorix chest pass to his left to Ford. 9 on the shot clock. Ford on the left wing, goes toward the left corner, cuts it back to his right, drives into the lane, gives it out to Zorix. Zorix going to drive it in, put it up over Tripp. It's no good. And a rebound loose, controlled by Chavichian. To Price Noel on the near side. Price Noel taking into the front court. Jabril will spin it on Ford, drive it left
nice
of the lane,
pass.
Now kick it to Fritz, and he missed the layup, but
the
he
ball.
Gets his own miss, and then is stripped of the ball by Malik Fitz.
Nice, should have dunked that ball.
He was caught between a dunk and a layup, and Shaquille just kind of got mentally tied up right there. Tough break, that should have been an easy deuce for the Tigers. Now Ford with a three, it's no good, but he got fouled.
You know,
and it's on Jahlil Tripp.
Tripp, to me, the last minutes look a little tired out there. They haven't given him a breather yet. And I don't know if he can play the whole game tonight at this pace. Didn't he foul the three-point shooter in the Pepperdine game late, too?
Thinking back.
At the end of the game, remember? They had three, and they made two out of the three.
Yeah, Colby Ross, free throw is up, and it is good for Jordan 92% Ford.
92% free throw shooter.
Yeah. Now, Ford's a 78% free throw shooter. 92 is Ross from Pepperdine. By the way, the way that game ended at Pepperdine, if you missed it, Colby Ross missed a wide-open three. That would have tied the game.
I watched the game.
Yeah, I know you did.
I watched on the internet, but yeah. I thought when they fouled the three-point shot, they were going to cut it to one, you know what I mean? But he missed the one.
Second free throw is good.
Tigers made good plays on the stretch, though. They made some key baskets.
St. Mary's now back in front, 15-14. Third one is up and good. So Ford banks all three. 16-14. We'll see if the Tigers can recover from that missed dunk slash layup and then the foul on the three-point shot. 16-14, St. Mary's, as up top it is Tripp. Jaleel holding, chest pass to the right side to Price Noel. Jabril off a screen by Hampshire, who's in for the first time. Dribbles to his right, takes it, and makes a long two. So James Hampshire has checked in for the first time. So it's Hampshire, Price Noel, Chavichian, Tripp, and Vereen on the floor. By the way, Hampshire sporting the white headband for the first time tonight. Attaboy, Hamp, the white headband. Looking good. Is on the right side. It's Dukas. Dukas trying to give a bounce pass. Entry is denied, so they keep it on the perimeter. Get it to the left side to Ford, who goes off the dribble, tries to go over Hampshire, and Hampshire says, I don't think so.
So you think the headband looks good, huh?
It's a cool look. I do.
My deal with headbands is I want them to wear them all the time. You know, if you're going to wear them all the time, it's part of the way you do. I cannot live with it. But if you're just wearing them once in a while out of the blue moon, I just couldn't see that.
Jeremiah Bailey checks in for Jaleel Tripp. Hampshire's got the hair a little bit longer, so I think that's why he switched, because that hair has gotten pretty long. Is Ford going to take a floater in the lane, and he knocks it down. He wanted a foul as well.
You got to keep him
called.
In front of you. You got to keep him in front of you. Make him shoot over you, not around you.
18-16 St. Mary's. Price Noel is on the right wing. Chest pass up top to Vereen. Vereen looking to his left, gives to Chavichian, curling to his right. Back to Vereen on the right wing. He dribbles into about 17 feet, takes it. It's no good. And there should have been a foul on a push in the back as Hampshire was bumped off that rebound, but no whistle. Could have been a foul on the shot, too, as Kuzi up top. Hands to Fitz, thought about a long three, instead drives it in, spins in the lane, goes over Hampshire. It rattles out. Rebound is loose. It's controlled by Hampshire. To Price Noel. Jabril will dribble to his left, drive down left of the lane, scoop it off the glass and in. There's Jabril Price Noel. Danis Jenkins has gotten to the scorer's table. They wanted Crockrell to get in there too, but he was stopped, and Pierre has a bump on his right cheek, so we'll keep an eye on that. But Crockrell wanted to come in, and Chris Ponce said he's not allowed to come in yet, so we'll see if anything's up there. As Kuzi gives to Fitz on the right wing. Fitz holding over his head. Fitz will chest pass up top to Ford. Seven on the shot clock. Ford's at the top of the circle, drives in. Ford goes into Hampshire, and the ball goes out of bounds. They say last touch by Pacific. Four on the shot clock, and St. Mary's will have it out of bounds with four on the shot clock when we come back after a timeout on the floor here at the Spano Center. We'll also check in on Nick Crockrell. This timeout comes with 7:07 to go in the first half. A good one in Stockton. It's all tied up. St. Mary's Gales 18, Pacific Tigers 18 on Fox Sports AM 1280.
I listen to Fox Sports AM 1280 at work. My coworker Janet, however, likes CC.
Back courtside of the Spano Center, Zach Beirutti alongside the great Bob Thomason. So glad to have you with us on Fox Sports AM 1280. All tied, Pacific and St. Mary's tied at 18 with 7:07 to go in the first half. Quick update, we just talked to Chris Pond, the head athletic trainer for the Tigers, and Pierre Crockrell, they're evaluating him for a head injury. He's not in a concussion protocol, but they're just evaluating him for a head injury. Again, he bumped heads with Tommy Kuzi early in this half, and he's got an abrasion on his face, like above his cheek, so they're just continuing to evaluate, but he is not in the concussion protocol. So St. Mary's has the ball out of bounds, 4 seconds on the shot clock. Tigers need some good defense here on the inbound. Hampshire's going to be the on-ball defender as Kuzi trying to inbound it. He does on a bounce pass to Fitz. Fitz bumps off Vereen, and they're calling offensive foul.
That's a good
on
call
Fitz.
Right there.
Vereen kind of now, got an arm bar and
backed
up.
Tripp has done that a couple times, bumping guys off, the same thing, and got away with it. So you have to be careful.
From our right to our left, it's Jabril Price-Noel into the front court. He gives to Vereen. Vereen chest pass up top to Jenkins. Danis dribbles to his right. Jenkins inside the right wing up top to Bailey. Left wing to Price-Noel. Jabril up top to Jenkins. Now to Price-Noel on the left wing. Jabril dribbles to his right. Switching on it on the screens. Price-Noel going to try and do it himself. Goes right of the lane. Up with a floater, and it's no good. Hampshire, though, an offensive rebound. 20-second reset on the shot clock. And they give it near midcourt to Price-Noel, who's running the point. Jabril off a Hampshire screen, dribbles to his left, now weaves it to his right. Price-Noel up top, drives into the lane, up with the left hand, off the glass and in.
He's playing his last two games. I mean, he's getting better and better. He's ready to explode out here.
Price-Noel playing at a very high level. And it's a 20-18 Pacific lead as we tick towards 6 minutes to go here in the first half. Price-Noel had 9 points in the last game at Pepperdine on Thursday. Near midcourt, it's Jordan Ford, gets it down low. This is Fotu trying to go in over Hampshire, and Hampshire denies him with a block off the glass. Pass on ahead to Danis Jenkins. Jenkins right wing, Price-Noel three, it's too strong. Rebound is loose, and they say out of bounds, last touched by Pacific. I thought it went out of bounds off of St. Mary's. I hear them saying Pierre is good, so that means Pierre Crockrell has been cleared to come back in. He is not at the scorer's table yet, but that's good news,
obviously.
I think
he was going to go in for Price-Noel. I'm not sure if he wants to do that right now, the way he's playing.
That's a good point. 5:43 and counting to go in the first half. 20-18 Pacific. On the right wing, it's Kuzi. Kuzi is standing at an angle, angling his way toward the bucket. Feeds it back out to Krebs, and now to Fitz on the left wing to Ford. Ford dribbling to his right. Ford, bounce pass to his right to Krebs. 8 to shoot. Krebs dribbling to his left. Goes down left of the lane. Ball fake toward the baseline. Up with a tough fadeaway. It's no good. And Hampshire with the rebound.
That was a really good move, but you made him shoot over you. You know, as long as you do that, there's a chance they can miss it.
Tigers getting into the front court quickly. There was nothing there, though, so they slow it down. Give it to Danis Jenkins. Jenkins dribbles to the top of the key. Slings it down low to Hampshire. Kind of a bad pass. Hampshire catches. Gives to Bailey near corner. Now in the near wing with 10 to shoot. Bailey takes a three, and it's off the mark. And a rebound taken by Tanner Krebs.
Hampshire needs to be a little more aggressive inside. Go over there and impose his will and try to score.
Ford's going to take a three in transition, and that's good. Jordan Ford gives the Gales the lead back. 21-20 St. Mary's. Talented scorer is Jordan Ford. And he is a 42% shooter from beyond the arc. Price-Noel on the far sideline. Gives it to Vereen, who beats his defender. Vereen has the ball knocked away in the lane, though, stolen by Krebs. Krebs one-on-one with Price-Noel, goes up and gets fouled by Jabril. The shot does not go in. They said double zeros. I think they're saying double zero is the shooter, and the foul should be on 22, Price-Noel. He's the only guy in the vicinity.
See, if you just told him who fouled, 22.
So Tanner Krebs at the line, 85% from the line, and his first one is up, and it is good. McCray, Tripp, and Crockrell checking in for Price-Noel, Hampshire, and Vereen. This game has featured 5 lead changes and 5 ties. Free throw is up and good for Krebs. So St. Mary's 23, Pacific 20. In the front court to Danis Jenkins, up top to Jeremiah Bailey, hands it to Jenkins, moving to his left. Danis on the left wing, hands to Crockrell, spins the dribble between two defenders, tries to lob it down low, knocked away and stolen. Ford into the front court, nearly had his pocket picked, somehow gets it back, feeds it out on the right wing to Kuzi, and now back up top to Ford. Ford to Krebs, a left wing three, and that is good.
He could have took a shot inside, but he had enough patience to bring it outside to get a good shot.
Tanner Krebs, 45% from beyond the arc. It's 26-20, St. Mary's by 6. And this is the largest lead for St. Mary's. Previously, it had been 5. Crockrell dribbling to his left. Chest pass to Tripp on the left wing. Jaleel dribbles to his right. Tripp trying to go in on the entire defense. Puts up a fadeaway. It's no good. Rebound taken by Bailey. He puts it up off the glass, but missed it.
Great rebound.
And a rebound taken by St. Mary's. Ford dribbling to his right. He's going to pull up for a straightaway three, and that is good.
That is hard to guard. It was a double screen, but the second guy's got to jump out there. You know, the first screener, and then they came with a second screener.
So that prompts Damon Sotomayor to use a timeout. It'll stretch, become the full media timeout, and we will take it as well. 3:28 to go in the first half. It's the St. Mary's Gales 29, the Pacific Tigers 20. And we are back to the Spano Center after this on Fox Sports AM 1280.
How long does it take to get to the forest?
That's not far.
What are we going to do? Hike?
Sure.
Are we there yet?
Yep, it's a short drive from your neighborhood to your naturehood. Visit discovertheforest.org, brought to you by the Ad Council and the U.S. Forest Service.
Manteca Adult School Education and Training Center for 18 years old and up is offering free and low-cost classes. Registration begins January 6th, 2020. Start the new year off right and open doors to your future. Classes in English second language, job skill development, high school diplomas, warehouse, forklift, and welding training. Call 858-7330 to open the doors to your future. That's 858-7330.
Manteca Adult School Education and Training Center, located on the corner of West Louise and Airport Way in Manteca.
Box. Oh. Sports.
Got it, it's good.
AM 1280.
Zach Beirute, Coach Bob Thomason, so glad to have you with us on Fox Sports AM 1280, Pacific Tigers men's basketball on the radio. And right now, St. Mary's has opened up its largest lead, 9 points, the Gales 29 and the Tigers 20. Lincoln Center is Stockton's premier shopping and dining destination. Enjoy boutique shopping, award-winning restaurants, and family-friendly atmosphere. Personal service is always in style at Lincoln Center, conveniently located at the corners of Pacific Avenue and Benjamin Hole Drive. What's changed here in the last minute for the Tigers?
Well, St. Mary's has been really patient. They've hit back-to-back threes. They've set good screens, and the Tigers are having a little lull in their scoring. It's that one area where they've taken a couple threes that I think are ill-advised, but now they got to get back and get that ball inside and make some good moves and get to the foul line. They're not getting fouled, driving the ball to the basket at all.
Tigers have made some substitutions. Price Noel is back in, as is Chavichian, out there with Amari McCray, Pierre Crockrell, and Jaleel Tripp, who drives right of the lane, goes up with the right hand and gets it to go, but they're going to call an offensive foul on Tripp. They're going to say that he pushed
did.
Off.
I think he did extend his arm, which I don't think he needed to do. But there's contact on the defense, too. They could have called that one before. See how he pushes that arm right there?
He kind of extends his arm and puts it around Krebs.
He's the one that got the contact. I mean.
So St. Mary's takes it over on a Pacific turnover, as it's going to be a backdoor cut by Ford. Shot wasn't there, but he gives it in the lane to Fotu with an easy two, and he's fouled.
What a great soft pass. I mean, he did a great job. So he's forcing people to come and help, and then he finds the open guy. This little center's putting easy buckets in there. That kills you. The tough shot St. Mary's making is not what's beating them right now. It's just those two or three easy layups they've had.
James Hampshire is back in without the headband. So Hamp is going headbandless for this rotation. Free throw for Fotu is up and no good, and the rebound going to be taken by Hampshire. St. Mary's 31 and Pacific 20 as we tick under 3 minutes to go in the first half. Crockrell into the front court. Crockrell up top, gives to Tripp on the left wing. Back to Crockrell. Pierre is calling the play. With his right hand extended in the air, looks to his left to Jaleel Tripp. Tripp off a Hampshire screen, dribbles to his right, crosses over in the lane, little head fake, Tripp a fadeaway, and it's good.
He banked it in.
Did he bank it? I couldn't tell.
Yeah, he did. I don't think he called that, but we'll take the 2 points.
Yes, we will, and a badly needed bucket for the Tigers. 31-22 St. Mary's. This is not a game where you figure the Tigers can get down big and come back. St. Mary's is not that type of team that's going to let you. As Ford dribbles to his right in the lane, scoops it off the window and in.
You know, as well as they played Ford, all of a sudden the last 3 minutes, Ford is starting to oppose his will in the game.
He's got 13 points right now as Chavichian has it in the high front court. Chavichian moving to his left, gives on the left wing to Price Noel. Jabril dribbles to his right. Price Noel is at the top of the circle off a screen, continues to his right on the right wing, drives it in. Price Noel scoops with the left hand, no, and they are going to call a foul here. And the foul is going to be on Fotu.
A lot of dribbling right now, a lot of one-on-one basketball. Not a lot of passing and cutting and moving. We'll see how that continues if the Tigers can do well.
So Price Noel is at the line, and he will attempt two free throws.
Tripp's got to get through this 2 minutes without picking up a third foul, too.
It's a good point, as the first one is up, and it is good.
He's taking them out right now, which might be a good job, but you don't want to get down too far to this team.
Price Noel is 4 of 8 on the season now from the line after that make. Second one is up and good. So it's 33-24, St. Mary's by 9 from our left to our right, Ford across the center court stripe. Ford directing traffic with his index finger is going to move to his left, and he's going to take a three, and it's off the mark. And the rebound, a long rebound, goes out to the far corner where Krebs tracks it down. Back out it goes to Ford.
You can't go over the screen. Cockwell went under that screen. You got to go over the top of that screen. You got to go over the top of it.
Ford in, inside the left wing is going to give it up top to Kuzi, and now to Fitz on the right wing. Fitz crosses over. Fitz in the lane with a left-hand runner. It's no good. Hampshire bothered that shot. The rebound is loose. Somehow Fitz gets it from the seat of his pants, tries to dunk it in, and Hampshire with the block. The ball is still loose on the near side. Fitz tracks it down again to Ford. Ford drives near the left elbow, leans in, and gets fouled. I mean, that is a fourth chance opportunity there for St. Mary's.
They're running down rebounds right now. The first one, to me, the Tigers were standing around a lot. They just weren't pursuing that ball.
So Ford has two shots, again, an 85%, or rather 78%, I should say, free throw shooter.
Fitz sure likes to drive middle from this wing. You know, he's getting to the middle too much, and he's using his strength to get right to the basket.
Free throw is up and good for Jordan Ford. Second one is up, and no good. He missed, a rare miss for Ford, and the rebound taken by Hampshire. 10-point St. Mary's lead, 34-24. Tigers played a great last minute of the first half at Pepperdine. Let's see if they could do that here again, as Danis Jenkins near midcourt almost had his pocket picked.
Get his hands up!
Jenkins gives to his left to Price Noel. Jabril up top to Jenkins off a screen, dribbles to his right. Jenkins backing up with 9 on the shot clock. Jenkins going to drive it in. Danis tries to scoop it. No, but he does get fouled and will be going to the line.
They're getting fouled the last two times, but these are really tough shots. I just don't think they can beat St. Mary's with tough shots.
So Jenkins at the line, and he will attempt two free throws.
This is a period of time where if you can just make two free throws, make a stop and score, you'll get into half being okay.
Jenkins 73% from the line, but his first one is no good. Second one for Danis is on its way. It's up and it is good. So Jenkins 1 of 2 from the line. It's 34-25, St. Mary's by 9. 43.2 seconds to go in the half. And from our left to our right, Jordan Ford across the center court stripe. Gives to Logan Johnson, who's checked in for the first time. Johnson is up top, dribbling to his left, hands it off to Ford. Ford off a screen, dribbles to his left, now weaves to his right, takes a right elbow jumper and knocks it down. Jordan Ford's having some kind of half.
And he didn't do much the first 10 minutes. The last 10 minutes have been all him.
Tigers can hold for the last shot here. 15 seconds on the game clock as Price Noel is handling the ball, dribbles to his left. Fakes a handoff to Chavichi and gives up top to Jenkins with 8 to shoot, 7, and now 6, 5. Jenkins dribbles to his left. He takes a 3, and it's too strong. Long rebound comes out to Krebs. A half-court heave, and that is no good. So St. Mary's leading by double digits at the half. As our score at intermission, St. Mary's 36 and Pacific 25. And this game started with the teams exchanging blows. I mean, pretty much blow for blow, they were leapfrogging the lead up until it was, I believe, tied at 18. And at that point, St. Mary's started to pull away a little bit.
The same thing happened to USF. USF was ahead of St. Mary's, you know, by about 8 or 9. And the game just kept on going. And St. Mary's all of a sudden tied it. All of a sudden, they're up 7 at halftime. And they just keep on grinding. They play the same way the whole game. The question is, can you maintain that pace and execution and shot selection and the discipline to do all the things they do? And they just kind of wear people out.
Is there, and we'll talk about this once we get into to the halftime, but is there anything that Pacific can do to kind of hinder Jordan Ford from what you're seeing?
Well, they did a great job the first 10 minutes. They went over screens. They helped really good. All of a sudden now he's creating some space, and they got to do a better job of that on-ball screen because he's going to face them all night. He's going to do things all night. But they got to cut off the easy shots. I think St. Mary's has had like six easy shots, and the Tigers, I don't know if they had one easy shot, you know?
Yeah.
And I think that's the whole difference in the game.
Well, we'll talk more about it when we get into our halftime report. We'll step aside for now. At intermission, our score, the St. Mary's Gales 36, the Pacific Tigers 25. And we're back in just a couple of minutes on Fox Sports AM 1280.
Hi.
Back inside the Alex G. Spano Center, we're just about a minute away from the start of the second half. Zach Beirute alongside Coach Bob Thomason. Let's take a look around the West Coast Conference at some scores. Two games have gone final. Santa Clara with an 80-63 win over San Diego. Tough start to league for San Diego as they open league play 0-2. LMU beat San Diego on Thursday, but a tough break for LMU. They had to go and go to BYU, and they got beat handily by BYU 63-38.
BYU's playing well. They got the player back, and they've been really pounding people lately.
Games that are at halftime, the shocker right now, Pepperdine and Gonzaga at the Kennel, 37-37. Gonzaga 21-point favorites in that game. And right now it's tied at the half, 37-37. So a nice effort made by Pepperdine so far. Keep in mind, Portland led Gonzaga by 7 at halftime on Thursday, and then Gonzaga stomped them in the second half. So we'll see what happens. Speaking of Portland, they have a 32-26 halftime lead on USF up at the Child Center in Portland. So there's some head turners right now around the WCC.
Called league play.
Yep, indeed. It is 36-25 St. Mary's here at halftime. The Tigers have the ball to start the second half, and they will move from our left to our right as Pierre Crockrell will receive the inbound pass, go to the right wing, give it up top to James Hampshire, who's starting the second half, gives to Danis Jenkins. Jenkins to Tripp, now to the right wing to Finstoon. Finstoon weaving up top, spins to the right, gives to Hampshire. Hampshire dribbles to his left, fakes a handoff. It wasn't there. Gives it near midcourt to Tripp. 10 on the shot clock. Tripp moving to the far left sideline. 8, now 7. Tripp cuts it back to his right. Trying to cross over, has to fade it away near the top of the key. It's no good. Finstoon bats the rebound back, but it's controlled by Malik Fitz. And the Gales have their first possession of the second half, moving from our right to our left, as Kuzi with it on the Powercat logo. Kuzi dribbles toward the right wing, gives it up top to Fitz, and Fitz now drives to his right. He's going to take a step back three from the right wing, and that is off the mark, and the rebound knocked toward the near corner and saved, or almost saved, from going out of bounds by Krebs, but the ball hit the sideline, and the Tigers will take over with the 19:09 to go in the first half, the second half, I should say. First minute of the second half is what I wanted to say, is Crockrell from our left to our right. Into the front court, hands it to Finstoon. Finstoon gives a bounce pass to Jenkins, to Finstoon on the right wing. Brock weaves the ball down by his knees, dribbles into the key and now into the lane, weaves it back out. 15 on the shot clock. Finstoon still with a long dribble, dribbling to his right. Finstoon stops the dribble now, gives an entry pass to Hampshire. Hampshire on the lower right block, gives it out to Crockrell, who drives into the lane, puts a floater up and gets two. Nice floater there by Pierre Crockrell, and they're going to call a foul after the made basket, I want to say. I want to say it's on St. Mary's. There's going to be a foul on Krebs. So count the basket. The foul is going to be on Krebs.
I don't know how they call it. He just tripped.
Yeah.
He tripped kind of over someone's foot and fell down. I don't see why there's any foul on Krebs, but...
So they're going to...
See, when you're ref like that, that means you're looking for stuff all the time. You shouldn't be looking for stuff. You should call the stuff you see.
They're going to look and...
The Tigers are going to start passing, moving the ball. Right now they're just dribbling, going one-on-one, shooting shots. And St. Mary's is too good a defense right now. I just don't think... You're going to have to do both, and... They've been having a lot of assists lately, and now they're kind of starting...
I'm trying to see what they're looking for here.
What's this? He pushed him.
It was some hand-to-hand combat underneath
but
the bucket.
They're just screening out. He trips and falls. They have to call a foul on that? Looks like it's just incidental contact. Hope they do so the Tigers get the ball after the basket. The basket has to count. They can't take away the basket.
No, they said the basket counts. I made sure I heard that. I think they were looking to see if there was anything up high.
No, they're just basketball playing.
Yeah.
Both guys weren't trying to hurt each other. They were playing aggressive.
Yeah, there's nothing there that we could see. So it's not so count the basket. It was not like a shooting foul. So the Tigers should get the ball, right?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Yeah, they're going to give him the blue ball. Yeah. It's like, what are you doing?
So the Tigers have the ball. 20 seconds. They want a 20-second reset on the shot clock.
Why is it 20 seconds? Isn't the start of possession?
Yeah, Stoudemire thought it should be 32. Anyways, they inbound to Chavichian, a right baseline.
Well, all they needed
two
is two
good.
Seconds.
That was a mess. That was a mess all the way around. Nonetheless, the Tigers off to a nice start here in the second half on a 4-0 run to cut it to 7. 36-29, St. Mary's. Cousy up top, shot fake, dribble to his right. Cousy trying to lean in and lost a handle on the ball, and Hampshire has the loose
Mary's
ball.
St. Mary's taking a couple poor shots.
Right corner, Danis Jenkins thought about a three. Shimmies, dribbles to his left, takes a runner, and it's around the rim and out.
That's a great shot. That's
really
a great
shot. Just could not get it to go, and the rebound taken by St. Mary's. To his right goes Jordan Ford, gives to Krebs on the right wing. Krebs hands it to Cousy. Cousy will back toward the far sideline. Cousy's going to drive it baseline right. Cousy goes around the defense. In the lane, goes up with a right-hand shot that's no good, and they're going to call foul on Pierre Crockrell.
Got to get his hands straight up. He's reaching in.
Cousy went around, like underneath the cylinder, made a U-turn in the lane.
You don't want to foul him on that shot.
So Cousy has two shots here at the line. Cousy is a 68% free throw shooter. These are his first free throws of the game. It's up, and it is good. That's Cousy's first point of the game. He hadn't taken a shot, has not taken a field goal. Second one up, and good. 17:54 to go in the second half. It's 38-29 St. Mary's by 9. Jenkins has it up top. Jenkins gives a bounce pass to his left to Crockrell inside the left wing. Crockrell gives to his left to Chavichian. He takes a three and it gets in.
Oh, big roll for
it
Tigers.
It deadened on the heel of the rim and it spun in.
See, now you're back into that 6-point game and now it's just a grind game and you just got to just get 2 points at a time.
38-32 St. Mary's as Krebs has it up top. Krebs gives it on the left wing to Jordan Ford. Ford fake right, dribble left. Now spins it back to his right. Ford gives a bounce pass to Fotu, and his shot is turned away by James Hampshire. And Danis Jenkins tracks down the loose ball. Into the front court, on ahead to Tripp. Driving in from the right wing. Slips a pass to Hampshire, who rucks the rim with a two-hand dunk.
Great pass off right there.
38-34, St. Mary's by 4 as we tick under 17 to go in regulation. Tigers off to a great start here in the second half. Up top, Fotu fakes a three, gives to Jordan Ford. He dribbles to his left. Ford spins it back in the key, goes toward the right, has the ball knocked out of his hands. It's loose on the floor. Someone's trying to call a timeout. Do they get it? They say jump ball. Possession arrow belongs to St. Mary's. So nobody really had possession, otherwise there would have been a timeout called. So 9 seconds on the shot clock.
Was that a jump ball?
It's a jump ball.
Well, that's good. That even though you had 9 seconds, you get the next jump.
Jordan Ford will inbound with James Hampshire, the on-ball defender on the inbound pass. The inbound is lobbed to Fitz in the key. Fitz drives left of the lane, and Fitz is going to put it up and
godly. Make him make that shot.
He missed the shot, but he did get fouled.
Two shots coming up on the game.
Two So Fitz is at the line. First one is up and no good. Fitz, a 79% free throw shooter. This one is up and good, so he's one of two from the line. 39-34, St. Mary's by five. Pierre Crockrell from our left to our right gives to Chavichian, now up top to Jaleel Tripp. He hands to Chavichian, moving toward the far left sideline. Hands to Crockrell, who dribbles to his right. To Chavichian on the left wing. Gary will spin the dribble to his right. He's loose for a three, and it's off the side of the rim, the left side. St. Mary's has the miss, and into the front court they go with Krebs on the left wing. Krebs dribbles to his right. Krebs hands to Ford near midcourt. Ford dribbling toward the far right sideline and now gives it to Zorix, who's in the game. Zorix up top to Ford. Ford dribbles to his left with 11 to shoot. Up top to Zorix. Zorix trying to lob it in. He does to Fotu right of the lane. Fotu trying to angle his way in. Goes to the baseline. Sneaks around Hampshire and lays it up and in.
Great move. Use the backboard on the other side of the rim to protect it.
Danis Jenkins gets quickly to the baseline left. He puts
He's
up a fadeaway
and
knocks
it down. Like that and steps back.
From our right to our left, Ford into the front court. 41-36, St. Mary's by five. Zorix up top to Ford. Ford dribbles to his right, now goes behind the back, crosses over, goes to the baseline, tried to go somewhere with the ball, I'm not sure, but he had it knocked away out of bounds. And it was last touched by the Tigers, so the Gales will have possession when we come back after this timeout on the floor from the Spano Center, where we have a good one cooking. This timeout comes with 15:31 to go in regulation. The St. Mary's Gales 41, the Pacific Tigers 36. We're back after this on Fox Sports AM 1280. At the box office, section L. 15:31 to go in regulation. The St. Mary's Gales 41, the Pacific Tigers 36. Zach Beirutti, Bob Thomason, glad to be with you. The Tigers have some spring in their step in the second half here, Coach. Pacific in this half has outscored St. Mary's 11-5.
Yeah, I mean, they've cut the lead in half. And when you're up double figures at home, down double figures, you need to cut that down by the first time out. And they did exactly that. Now their job is to cut two or three or four more points off to the 12-minute mark. And then from there on, it's a dogfight.
Be sure to stick around following tonight's game. We'll chat with our City of Stockton Human Resources hardworking player of the game. Check out the City of Stockton's website, www.stocktonca.gov/jobs. They offer competitive salaries and great benefits. Baseline left forward inbounds, 15 seconds on the shot clock, and he inbounds to Fotu in the left corner. Fotu gives to Ford. Ford skips it to near midcourt, 8 to shoot. Ford dribbles to his left, he's on the left wing, slings it up top to Zorix. Zorix drives right of the lane, tries to go over Shaquille Fritz, and
he
the shot went nowhere.
Shot.
Did he get a piece of
yeah.
it? I didn't see. So Fritz with a partial block. Now Crockrell, a no-look pass on the baseline to Jaleel Tripp, who lays it up and in. 41-38, the Tigers, who at one point trailed by as many as 11, are within three. 41-38, St. Mary's, ticking under 15 minutes to go here in regulation. Dribbling to his right is Ford. Ford is on the right wing. They double-team him, give to Zorix, right corner. Now back to Ford on the right wing near the far right sideline. Ford drives with his left hand into the lane, gives it out to Fitz with six to shoot. Fitz crosses over, spins in the lane. Fitz goes up over two defenders. Shot won't go, but there on the weak side to clean it up is Fotu.
They need help. When guys penetrate, you've got to rope down and the guards have to box those guys out.
Crockrell in the front court moving to the near wing, hands it off to Jenkins. Jenkins up top to Chavichian. Chavichian rotates over his head, gives to Crockrell at the left elbow. Crockrell gives a bounce pass, baseline left to Tripp, who beats everybody to the bucket, goes up, scoops it off the glass and in.
You know,
Jaleel Tripp just explosive.
Fitz for them has not played a great game. You know, he's one of their second lead scorers, and he's been really struggling this whole game.
Zorix is near midcourt, gives it to his left to Krebs, and now further left to Fitz, who dribbles to the point. Fitz guarded by Tripp, shovels to Ford. It's a three-point Gales lead, 43-40 St. Mary's. To Krebs on the left wing, dribbling to his right, through the key, toward the bucket, puts it up, no, but he does get fouled. And they're going to count the basket. They're going to say goaltend.
Oh, my goodness.
Foul's going to be on Gary Chavichian, and they're going to score the basket, so this will be an and-one opportunity.
Here.
Got a replay here. And that was on the Fritz block from a few moments ago.
It looked like it was a good call right there. He might have been on the way down.
This has not been a well-officiated game in my mind. It's kind
of
helter-skelter.
There's been a couple, calls that are weird. But I don't think it's affected yet the game so far.
46-40, St. Mary's by six. From our left to our right, Crockrell into the front court. We did not get a look on our replay monitor at that goaltend that they called.
Yeah, I did.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, I think it was a good call.
Tripp's going to go to the bucket, hit the floor hard, and get fouled. So Tripp is on the floor.
Yeah, and they the showed a replay of it. It looked like the ball was hanging and then was on the way down when he blocked it. I hate to admit it, but that was a good call.
So Tripp will be at the line here to attempt two free throws. 46-40, St. Mary's by six. First one is up and good for Jaleel. Second one is up and good, so Tripp makes them both. 46-42, St. Mary's by four. 13:36 and counting to go in the second half. Ford is on the left wing, dribbles to his right, slings it back to his left to Fotu. He almost missed it. Fotu is going to go up over Fritz, but to not make the shot. That was good defense by Fritz. They thought Fotu had traveled, but no call. As Crockrell on the right wing, dribbles to his left, lobs it down low to Fritz, who receives, kicks it out to Tripp. It's a three, and it will not go. Tripp continues to be cold. That was a pretty good look, though, and off a touch pass from Fritz. And I think Shaquilo thought that ball was going to be over his head, so that's why he touched it toward Tripp on the far side. As Kuzi scoops to the bucket, his shot blocked by Fritz, but the loose ball gotten in, and a layup missed by Alex Dukas, who's just checked into the game. Tigers catching a break there. They trail by four as Tripp into the front court, into the key, into the lane, up with the right hand, off the glass and in.
He's a handful right now.
2-point game, St. Mary's 46 and Pacific 44. And there's a whistle. I don't know if anybody called a timeout. I think Randy Bennett may have called a timeout. If so, it's going to stretch and become the full media.
I thought Fritz should have come down with that ball. I don't think he could have dunked the lob, but if he comes down with it and do a lift fake and power it in. He passed that ball from up above to outside. I think he'd be 6'8", go down, shot fake, muscle that ball in.
I think he thought, Coach, and we're going to take a break here in a moment, I think he thought that that ball may maybe passed over his head, so maybe he, in anticipating that, thought about
well,
throwing it to the far
side. Well, if you catch the ball and pass it, you should come down with it.
It's true. Well, it's a timeout, going to be a timeout on the floor with 12:44 to go in regulation. St. Mary's 46, Pacific 44 on Fox Sports, AM 1280.
Westwood One presents NFL.
12:44 to go in regulation. We have a great game here at the Spano Center. St. Mary's 46 and Pacific 44. Checking the second half numbers, the Tigers are a blistering 8 of 12 from the floor in the second half. St. Mary's is 3 of 12. For the game, the Tigers are shooting 51%. The Gales are shooting 36% for the game and yet maintain a 2-point lead with 12:44 to go in regulation.
This team they have in there right now has been really dynamic tonight. They've been scoring, they're playing good defense, they're athletic, and see how far along they can go with them.
It's like James Hampshire is going to get back in. It's like St. Mary's had an injured player is what the officials are talking about. So it looks like they want to get Jock Perry in. So Hampshire will check in for Shaquilo Fritz. So Jock Perry does come in. It is Tanner Krebs, Jock Perry, Jordan Ford, Tommy Kuzi, and Malik Fitz for the Gales. Jabril Price-Noel, James Hampshire, Jaleel Tripp, Pierre Crockrell, and Danis Jenkins for the Tigers. Gales moving from our right to our left as Fitz hands to Ford. Ford top the circle, dribbles to his left, hands to Kuzi, moving to his right. Kuzi continues to his right toward the right wing, guarded by Jenkins, who's screened off. Now Kuzi weaves toward the baseline. Kuzi feeds it back out to Krebs. Krebs dribbles to his left. Krebs is in the key, now going left of the lane. They're going to call a foul here on Jabril Price-Noel, they say, for a hand check. So baseline left, it'll be Kuzi to inbound. Kuzi inbounds to Krebs. He takes a shot that is an air ball from baseline left. But Jock Perry is there to clean it up. Perry goes in on Hampshire up with the left hand and gets it to rattle in.
That was a good move right there. You got to get that rebound right there.
Big second chance opportunity there for the Gales, who extend the lead back to four. It's 48-44. St. Mary's is dribbling to his right is Price Noel. Jabril up top to Tripp, and now on the left wing to Jenkins, up top to Crockrell. Off a screen, dribbles to his right. Pierre goes right of the lane, now spins it back. Crockrell near the perimeter with seven on the shot clock. Need to come up with something quick here. Crockrell weaves through the defense. Pierre gets it toward Perry. That's David versus Goliath. Crockrell heaves a desperation shot up off the bottom of the backboard. He just had nowhere to go there.
You're dribbling the ball too much. I mean, you got to pass the ball. It can't be just... When you're dribbling the ball that much, nobody else is moving. There's no spacing.
So that takes us to a timeout on the floor here from the Spano Center. This comes with 11:39 to go in the second half. St. Mary's 48, Pacific 44 on Fox Sports AM 1280. 11:39 to go in regulation. Zach Beirute, Bob Thomason, glad to have you with us. St. Mary's 48, Pacific 44 here at the Spano Center. And in the second half, the Tigers have outscored St. Mary's 19-12. It's amazing, the Tigers are shooting, and we just went over it, 51% from the floor. The Gales are shooting 36% from the floor. And yet, St. Mary's maintaining a four-point lead. So to some extent, St. Mary's is being, as they like to say, outstatted here tonight, but they're doing what St. Mary's does, and they are maintaining a lead, hanging
in
there.
Yeah, I mean, St. Mary's is not getting easy shots they've been getting. They missed a couple layups. So you got to keep the pressure on St. Mary's. They have a lot to lose. They're getting ready to get right back in the top 25. There's a lot of pressure on them to be able to perform, win this game. If the Tigers can just keep it simple, pass the ball, move the ball, and let Tripp do his thing. They can't guard him right now.
From our right to our left, Kuzi into the front court for St. Mary's. To Fitz, and Fitz nearly traveled. He gives to Ford, and now to Kuzi. Kuzi stutter step dribble to his left, gives it out to Ford on the right wing. Ford stutter step, no travel call, goes to the bucket, tries to scoop it up, and his shot blocked by Hampshire, and it goes out of bounds, last touch by Pacific. That's 13 seconds on the shot clock. Baseline left, Ford will inbound to Perry. Perry is going to drive it along the baseline. Hampshire working on him. He puts it up over Hamp. It's no good. The tip back is no good, and Hampshire clamps the rebound. To Crockrell, our left to our right. Into the front court goes Pierre. Drives toward the left elbow, stops, gives it out to Tripp. Now to the right wing to Jenkins. Danis dribbles to his left, gives it back to Tripp. Jaleel working on four, drives to the baseline, is swarmed, gives it out to Jenkins. He'll take a three, and it's good.
Great job by Tripp. Forces the double team, pass the ball to the open man.
For Danis Jenkins, he has now 8 points, and the Tigers within a point, 48-47, St. Mary's by one. Dribbling to his left is Ford. Ford gives it back to his right to Kuzi. Kuzi holding the ball over his head. Kuzi off his screen, dribbles to the right, weaves in the baseline, gives in the corner to Krebs. Krebs from the near corner, driving baseline, being worked on by Price Noel, and they're gonna call a hand check foul on Price Noel. Baseline left, Kuzi inbounds to Ford. Ford guarded by Jenkins. Ford spins the dribble to his right in the lane, lobs it up, and gets the bounce off the front of the rim.
It was amazing.
St. Mary's 50, Pacific 47, 10-17 and counting to go in regulation. Crockrell in the high front court, dribbles toward the far side, hands to Price Noel, now to Jenkins up top. Jenkins dribbles to his right. Jenkins goes right of the lane, off the glass, no, but he does get fouled, and the foul is going to be on Tommy Kuzi. The last time the Tigers had the lead was when it was 20-18. That was with 4:58 left in the first. This is a shooting foul here, so Danis will be at the free throw line to shoot two. Danis Jenkins, a 73% free throw shooter. And his first one is up and good. It rimmed in. Danis is 2 of 3 from the line now in this game. Second one is up and good. 50-49, St. Mary's by one with 10:06 to go in the second half. Shaquilo Fritz is going to check in. And Fritz takes over for James Hampshire. It is Fitz, Ford, Kuzi, Fotsu, and Krebs. The starting five is out there right now for St. Mary's as Ford dribbles to the far right sideline, gives it up top to Fotsu. Now to Krebs on the left wing. Skip pass to Kuzi. A right corner three is not going to count because of an offensive foul on Fotsu away from the ball. The shot did not go in, and away from the ball they called the offensive foul. So the Tigers bring it into the front court now as we are under 10 minutes to go in regulation. St. Mary's 50 and Pacific 49. Up top it is Jenkins off a screen dribbling to his right, takes a pull-up jumper and it's off the mark and the rebound taken by Ford. Did you like that shot there by Jenkins?
I just thought it was so early in the shot clock he could probably get a better look.
Ford dribbling to his left. He's on the left wing. Ford, a step back three. Look out. That is off the mark, though. And a rebound taken by Jenkins. To Tripp. Tripp along the far side from our left to our right into the front court. Jaleel to Jenkins near midcourt. Jenkins back to Tripp on the far side. 15 on the shot clock. Tripp starts to dribble off a Fritz screen. He moves to his right. Tripp now back to his left. Lobs it down low to Shaquilo. Shot fake Shaquilo, and he traveled. He had it.
There, he's unsure when he catches the ball what he wants to do. Catch it, go make a move.
It's a nice play they ran for him.
Yeah.
James Hampshire's going to get in there for Shaquilo Fritz.
Yeah, I would take him out right now just because he made that one mistake. He's been blocking shots and playing great defense out there.
Under 9 minutes to go, 50-49, St. Mary's by one. Dribbling to his right is Kuzi. Kuzi right of the lane, scoots to the bucket, lays it off the glass.
Those are easy shots and you just can't give up. You know, just too hard to score tonight.
Jenkins up top to Price Noel. Jabril gives a bounce pass to Crockrell on the right side. Back to Price Noel, who rises up for three. It's off the mark, and the rebound taken by Jaleel Tripp. Good offensive rebound. I thought he may have been fouled, too. Tripp angling his way in and trying to go into the lane. The foul is going to be on the floor. And the foul is going to be on the Gales. It will be on, I haven't signaled it yet, on Tanner Krebs. That's the second personal on Krebs. It's the fifth team foul on St. Mary's. So baseline right, Crockrell inbounds, 20 seconds on the shot clock. Crockrell looking for someone to get loose, and he lobs it into Jenkins. Inside of 8.5 to go in regulation. Jenkins hands it off to Crockrell on the near side. Pierre dribbling to his right off of a Hampshire screen, now to his left in the key. Crockrell spins in the lane. A floater with the right hand is no good. The rebound taken by Fritz.
He shoots himself out of the game.
Rebound was taken by Fitz, not Fritz, beg your pardon. Shaquilo Fritz is on the bench, but Fitz had the rebound there. Hands it off to Jordan Ford. Ford on the left wing. Hands to Kuzi. Kuzi near midcourt, dribbles to his left, weaving through the defense. Kuzi drives right of the lane, tries to feed it out to Ford. He does, well, and he's open for three, and he knocks it down.
Why is he open, though? Just stay with him. You know, you got to play a denial defense on him. You got to stay with him. Make other people score.
So that stretches the St. Mary's lead to 6, and Pierre Crockrell wants a timeout as he takes it into the front court and signals the timeout. This will stretch, become the full media timeout. We will take it as well. 7:40 to go in regulation. The St. Mary's Gales 55, the Pacific Tigers 49 on Fox Sports AM 1280. 7:40 to go in regulation at the Spano Center. St. Mary's has a 6-point lead. It'll be Pacific basketball when we leave the timeout. The Tigers have not scored in the last 2 minutes and 18 seconds. In that span, the Tigers have gone 1-for-4 on their last 4 field goal attempts.
Tripp's got to get the ball back again. And, you know, I'm not saying the 2 shots they've taken are horrible shots, but they got to get him more involved in what they're going to do.
To your point, Coach, Jaleel Tripp is 3 of his last 4 from the floor, so they'd like to get him the ball.
St. Mary's can't guard him, so you have to get him in situations where he's going to create a shot for the post guys or a perimeter guy.
7:40 to go. Plenty of time here in regulation. The Tigers trailing by six, but they need a basket to kind of get back on track, you would figure. Inbound to Fritz, who's back in. Hands to Jenkins, hands to Tripp. Jaleel weaves through the lane. Jaleel trying to go up from the left side. Runs into Jock Perry. They're going to get to Perry for a foul, and they're going to say a shooting foul. So Jaleel's going to the line.
Well, that's him just lowering his shoulder, going in there, and St. Mary's didn't have really good position, so he got the foul. That's what I was talking about. You know, put the game in his hands this last 7 minutes.
At the line, at zero, Jaleel Tripp. So Tripp is at the line. Jaleel with 16 points, 4 rebounds, and 2 assists in this game. Free throw is up and good. So that ends a 2-minute, 27-second scoreless drought for the Tigers.
I don't see taking Jaleel out right now because he's gave him some scoring. I know he hasn't scored this half.
Crockrell is in, and Price Noel has come out. Second one is up and good for Jaleel Tripp, now has 18 points. 55-51, St. Mary's by 4. 7:30 and counting to go in regulation. A good one here at the Spano Center. On the left side, it's Fitz. Fitz up top to Kuzi. Kuzi guarded by Crockrell. Kuzi shimmies to his left. Kuzi lobs it down low to Perry. Fritz closes out on him, and Perry's still able to go up,
great
put
pass.
It off the window.
This
and
is
in.
A great pass. And the center did a great job getting the ball and kind of crab-stepping back in.
And Fritz closed out on him, but Jock Perry able to find a little space there to put it off the window and in for the layup. 57-51, St. Mary's back to a 6-point lead. Crockrell is at a crouch, giving a bounce pass to Tripp. He's near the left elbow. Tripp facing the hoop now is going to drive it in, and Jaleel runs into a defender and an offensive foul.
Good as call Fritz right fell there. Backwards. Took it right in the chest.
That's the third personal on Jaleel. Getting a look on the replay. Yeah, he went right, his shoulder right into Tanner Krebs. So the Gales in the front court leading 57-51. Fitz up top to Kuzi. Kuzi dribbles to his left. Kuzi runs toward the bucket, tries to put it up, is blocked violently from behind by Shaquilo Fritz.
Does Fritz get to the ball quick or what?
Oh yeah, he closed out quick. He's so long too.
Just gotta get a little more confidence with the offensive game just to put balls back, make quick move.
6:40 to go in regulation. St. Mary's 57, Pacific 51. Kuzi baseline left, inbounds to Krebs, and he has the ball stripped and stolen by Crockrell. Crockrell, pass ahead to Tripp. Jaleel goes to the bucket, puts it up, no, but he does get fouled, I believe, by Malik Fitz. And indeed, the foul is on Fitz. I was wondering what Pierre had options there. He had a player that was even more far ahead than Tripp was. I'm not sure who it was, but I thought a good decision. He got the ball in Jaleel's hands, and he got
to. I think anytime he gets to Jaleel right now, he can get him to the basket and either get a power layup or a foul.
Tripp with 18 points, second in this game only to Jordan Ford, who leads all scorers with 21. The free throw is up and no good for Jaleel.
Pushed out a little, get it up over that front rim.
Second one is up, and around the rim and out. He missed them both, and that is a rarity. Tripp
that's
usually very reliable from
you.
The line. 57-51, St. Mary's is Kuzi to Fitz. Fitz in the high front court, hands to Kuzi, who dribbles to his left. Kuzi hands it off to Ford. Ford backpedals to the Powercat logo. Ford to his left. Ford is not going to have an opportunity to do anything. They call an illegal screen on Tanner Krebs.
You know, you hit screens hard nowadays. They call them illegal screens more than they do other.
And that is the second personal on Krebs. It's Chavichian on the right wing. Hands it up top to Danis Jenkins. Jenkins bounce pass to his left to Crockrell. Crockrell now at the point. Gives a pass to his right to Chavichian. They're right up on him. They know that Gary wants to shoot. They get it to Jenkins on the left wing. Lobs it down low to Tripp. They double team Tripp. He slings it out or tries to Chavichian. And Kuzi with the steal. On ahead to Ford. Ford on the left wing, guarded by Crockrell. Ford going to take a step back three, and that is no good. And the rebound taken by Jaleel Tripp. Tripp head up into the front court. 57-51 St. Mary's. Tripp is at the left elbow, weaves it out, gives to Crockrell. Tigers want to run some offense here as we tick toward 5.5 minutes to go in regulation. Chest pass to Jenkins on the left side. He hands to Tripp. Jaleel on the far left side up top to Crockrell. Crockrell looking to his left. He's going to dribble to his left with eight on the shot clock. Pierre drives it into the left elbow, takes a fadeaway, and it's off the mark. Long rebound tracked down by Tripp. Gives it out to Jenkins. A straightaway three, and that is short. And a rebound taken by Krebs.
Well, they had their chance. They had their chance.
57-51, St. Mary's maintains a six-point lead.
Two ball screen. Pop it up.
To his left goes Ford. Ford goes down left of the lane, has a ball fake toward the baseline, pivots off his left foot, feeds it back out to Krebs. Nine on the shot clock. Krebs got a drive in on Chavichi, and Krebs puts it up. Is blocked by Shaquille Fritz. Loose ball to Jenkins. On ahead to Tripp, and Jaleel's going to go up and get fouled by Malik Fitz. Another great block.
Oh.
Well, Shaquille Fritz is entertaining to watch on the defensive end. That is for certain. And for Fritz, that is his fourth block of the game. Fritz has four blocks. Hampshire has four blocks for the Tigers. And for good measure, Danis Jenkins has two blocks.
At the line, number zero, Jaleel Tripp.
57-51, St. Mary's. Tripp has a chance to redeem himself after missing two free throws a minute ago. First one is up and
he's
no good.
He's off the back rim right now. He's pushing out at the ball a little. You know, you always got to push up and get over that front rim. Most people miss long. And that's why you want to go over that front rim. So if it's a little long, you still make it.
But Jaleel's sitting on 18 points. He is 4 of 7 from the line now. Second one is up and good. So there you go. Ends a nearly a three-minute scoring drought for the Tigers. 57-52, St. Mary's by 5. Our right to our left, it's in the hands of Kuzi on the right side. Kuzi lobs it up top to Perry. Perry facing the hoop, being guarded by Shaquille. Hands it to Kuzi, who curls the dribble to his right. Now probes, puts it off the window and in, and he's going to the line.
See, again, you're getting, how are you getting all the way to the basket on those drives?
Pierre Crockrell with the foul.
Make 12 shoot over you. Make him shoot over you, not angles. Yeah, they still, Tigers still have plenty of time. I mean, plenty of time in this game.
Free throw is up and it rattles in. 60-52, St. Mary's by 8. 4.5 to go in regulation. Crockrell takes the inbound and goes from our left to our right. Pierre on the right wing up top to Jaleel Tripp. Tripp to Crockrell on the right side. Crockrell gives to Chavichi and a turnaround straightaway three, and that is off the mark, off to the right, and the rebound taken by St. Mary's.
Jenkins had a good three. They've had some free throws. That was a great three. Those are shots you have to make to beat a good team.
60-52, St. Mary's by 8 is on the left side. It is Fitz. Fitz on the left wing, content to hold the ball and to hand it off to Ford as we tick under 4 minutes to go in regulation. Ford trying to lob it down low to Fitz. He receives it on the end line, slings it out to the far side to Krebs for a three, and that is a bad brick. And a rebound taken by Jaleel Tripp. Tigers want to go a little bit here. Tripp into the front court. He's on the right wing. Drives it through the defense, scoops it off the window and in. So Tripp now with 21 points.
He's got to do that more often.
60-54. St. Mary's lead is cut to 6 with 3:33 and counting to go in regulation. Fitz hands it to Kuzi. Kuzi dribbling to his left, hands it to Ford. Ford near midcourt, weaving through the defense, and he is fouled. And it is going to be an arm bar on Chavichi, and it's going to be 1-1.
Can't foul a good free throw shooter down the stretch here. It's like 2 points.
I'm not sure who they got for that foul, but we'll find out here. It's going to be on Crockrell, and that is his fourth. Not on Chavichi, but rather Crockrell. That's his fourth. So it's going to be 1-1 for St. Mary's when we come back after a timeout on the floor. Comes with 3:24 to go in regulation, and down the stretch they come in Stockton. St. Mary's 60, Pacific 54 on Fox Sports AM 1280. St. Mary's leading by 6 with 3:24 to go in regulation. Still plenty of time here at the Spano Center. We're keeping our eye on the Gonzaga-Pepperdine game. Gonzaga with a 69-63 lead on the Waves. That is with just under 4 minutes to go up in Spokane, so Pepperdine is hanging in there. Portland with a 61-56 lead on San Francisco. That's with 3.5 minutes to go up in Portland. So a lot
that'd
of intriguing
be a big
action.
Upset there.
A lot of intriguing action in the West Coast Conference tonight as The Tigers here trailing 60-54. 1-1 coming for Jordan Ford, 4-78% free throw shooter.
Well, Tigers defense has been great. St. Mary's only shooting 38% for the game. You can't do better than that.
Free throw number one is up and good, so Ford gets another. Dan Fotu checks in, and Jock Perry is out for St. Mary's. Again, 3:24 to go in regulation.
One thing about St. Mary's, Randy never substitutes good guards. They play the whole game.
Yeah.
You know, they always play 40 minutes.
Let's go, baby, come on.
They never come out. They use those timeouts, you know, to rest them.
Ford has played 35 minutes in this game, as the Tigers have it trailing 62-54. As Jenkins dribbles to his right of the lane, Danis goes toward baseline right. Jenkins in the right corner, doubles back along the baseline, dumps it to Shaquille Fritz, who dribbles one time, gets loose for a two-hand rim rocker.
That's where St. Mary should really foul right there on Fritz, you know, make him make two free throws.
62-56, St. Mary's by six. 3 minutes and now ticking under three to go in regulation.
That was a great pass by Jenkins.
Top, it is Ford. Ford on the right wing gets it down low to Fitz. Fitz banging his way in on Jahlil Tripp. Fitz goes up and with a left hand misses.
He's had a tough game tonight. He's a good player. I've seen him score 25 a lot of nights.
Rebound taken by Tripp. Tripp wants to take it to the 10. He does, and he lays it up and in. 62-58. It's a four-point game now, and here come the Tigers. 2:30 and counting to go in regulation. Let's see if the Tigers come up with another stop as Fitz dribbles to his right, hands to Cousy. Cousy hands to Ford. Ford near midcourt dribbles to his left, weaves through the defense, goes to his right, now back to his left, takes a three and it's off the mark and the rebound taken by Shaquille Fritz to Jahlil Tripp up the far left sideline. Tripp is on the left wing. Tripp is going to take it in. Tripp trying to go into the defense, yeah. And they're going to call a foul.
That was a good call.
I don't know. I think Tripp may have fumbled the ball a little bit, but the foul is going to be on Tanner
Krebs. I thought he
got
fouled, then he fumbled the ball, but we'll watch the replay maybe.
That's what Randy Bennett is saying. He's saying that he lost the ball. Nonetheless, the Tigers will take it, and Jahlil Tripp is at the line. Tripp with 23 points. He's 5 of 8 from the line in this game. First one is up and good. Tripp with the 24 points, working on a new season high. Second one is up and good. It rimmed in. It's now a career high for Jahlil Tripp, 25 points. And the Spano Center comes to life, 62-60. St. Mary's lead is cut to two. The Tigers on a 6-0 run in the last minute and 20 seconds. On the left wing, it's Krebs. Krebs dribbles to his right. Krebs trying to drive in, Chavichian denying, gives a bounce pass on the baseline to Cousy. Cousy spins in the lane, goes up, gets blocked, but they're gonna call Crockrell for a foul. And that is gonna be the fifth foul on Pierre Crockrell. He is fouled out. So Crockrell has fouled out.
He got him across the neck.
The replay confirms it. Pierre fouls out with 6 points on 3 of 5. Crockrell tonight, 2 rebounds, 2 assists, a steal.
Pierre played a pretty good game tonight.
Yeah.
You know, a tough environment.
He's been playing so
guards.
Well.
You know, he did a good job.
So Cousy is at the line. And the first one is up, and it rattles in for Tommy Cousy. 1:44 to go. 63-60 St. Mary's. Second one is up and good for Cousy. And Randy Bennett wants a timeout. It's going to be a full timeout. Let's just keep it here, and we can talk about what could shape up here and happen down the stretch. St. Mary's 64, Pacific 60. You have plenty of time, 1:44 to go. Obviously, you have a guy in Jahlil Tripp who's taken the game over for you with a career-high 25 points. I imagine you want him to keep driving, but I'd imagine Randy's going to figure out some way to keep that from happening, you think?
He hasn't so far. But I think you have to continue to do that, keep him aggressive. But he has to also, if he gets stuck with a double team, he's got to find the open man. I thought Jenkins did a great job driving baseline and then dumping it off to Fitz for a dunk. I think they just got to keep on taking good shots. You don't want to take hero shots. You want to take good basketball shots. If you miss those good basketball shots, hey, you miss them, you know. But you don't want to take some silly shots and look back saying, well, you know, what if? But you're going to get about three or maybe four possessions. That's all you're going to get in the game.
How fast do you want to go here if you're the Tigers?
I think you don't want to use clock. You want to just go play basketball. And, you know, you have time right now to call exactly what play you want to run. Now you come out here and run it. So you don't want to rush it, but you don't want to take too much time either because they still have to make stops and score. But if you keep the pressure on St. Mary's, they're going to come down where there's some pressure on the road for them because they're supposed to win this game. Everybody thinks they're supposed to win that game.
Tripp, Price, Noel, Chavichian, Jenkins, and Fritz. Again, Crockrell has fouled out of this game. It's Price, Noel into the front court. Hands to Jenkins. Jenkins gives to his left to Tripp. Tripp is up top. He's going to drive it with his left hand to his left. And they're going to call foul on the floor. It's going to be on Fotu.
Fitz can't guard him.
Or Fitz, I beg your pardon. For St. Mary's, that is their 10th foul. Double bonus here for Jaleel Tripp. So Tripp with a game high 25 points, joined in double figures by Jabril Price, Noel, and Danis Jenkins, who, by the way, is in double figures for the third time this season, talking about Danis, as the free throw for Jaleel is up and good. Tripp working on a new career high. He's got 26. Austin Vereen checks in for Jabril Price, Noel. Second one is up and no good. The rebound taken
again
by Fitz. It's a fourth missed free throw for Jaleel Tripp in this game. Three-point game, 64-61 St. Mary's. Tigers looking for a stop here as we tick under a minute and a half to go in regulation. Jordan Ford takes it near midcourt, guarded by Danis Jenkins. Tigers have played so well tonight. Ford dribbling to his left on the left wing, gives it up top to Krebs, a straightaway three, and that's too strong, and the rebound pops out to Jenkins. To Jaleel Tripp, a minute 10 and counting to go in regulation. Chavichian thought about a three, now he'll take it and make it. And we are tied with a minute 3 to go at the Spano Center. Chavichian a step to his left. He'd not had the eye on the bullseye all night until now. Gary Chavichian, 1 of 4 from beyond the arc, and that is a beauty to tie this game at 64. 47 seconds to go, and the Spano Center is alive. Ford on the near side. Ford crosses over to his right. Ford shimmies on Tripp, who's not giving an inch. He lobs it down to the baseline to Fitz. Fitz looks like he pushed off on Jenkins. Goes up, gets two, but they're going to call an offensive foul finally on Malik Fitz. Well, he was pushing off the whole time. ...64-64 and a timeout called by Pacific with 36 seconds to go.
Well, you're in a...
And also, by the way, 5 fouls for Fitz. He's fouled out. Yeah. That's his 5th.
You know, 36 seconds to go. That's where it's always tough because you got to shoot the ball. You know what I mean? And if you get an offensive rebound, you got to remind the guys, unless it's a gimme layup, bring the ball back out and go for the last shot.
It's like Price Noel is going to check in. So now do you hold for the last shot or do you hold until you get down as far as you can go?
Well, you know, if you shoot with 1 second on the shot clock, there's going to be 7 seconds in the game. And by the time it goes up there, and you won't have a lot of time, but St. Mary's can call a timeout. I just think that there's enough time where you're going to probably have to go for a good shot. You're going to take a good shot. And then if you don't score, you got to get back and play defense without fouling. You know what I mean? Because St. Mary's is probably going to do some driving to the basket unless Ford shoots outside.
Chavichian, by the way, after that game tying three, he's now 2 of 5 from outside. I said 1 of 4, but that was a later stat. He's 2 of 5 from beyond the arc. So just a second made three. Chavichian now with 8 points.
He's got ice water in his veins.
Yeah, so he does.
He'll shoot the ball. That's what you like. You like guys that'll shoot the ball.
He is
if they're
not
good
afraid.
Shots, and he had good shot, he had good balance.
Chavichian, by the way, thought about shooting it right away, and then he had a step to his left and found the angle that he liked.
This is where you got to, you know, get down. If you get fouled or get the free throw line, that's good too.
The last Pacific lead was when they led 20-18 with 4:58 to go in the first half. And they
you know,
have
sometimes
a chance.
Against good teams, you only want to beat them right at the end. You don't want to get ahead too early where they can come back.
Right. It's going to be Tripp, Chavichian, Jenkins, Fritz, and Price Noel on the floor for the Tigers. Again, Fitz has fouled out for St. Mary's. Chavichian will advance the ball from our left to our right into the front court. 30 seconds to go in the game. Again, a 6-second differential, shot clock to game clock.
I don't know.
Chavichian's bleeding the clock near midcourt here. 17, 16, 15. Chavichian moving to his right now. Gary's going to give it up top to Price Noel. 12, 11, 10 to shoot. To Jenkins on the left wing. Jenkins up top to Tripp. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. It's going to be a 3 for Tripp. It's short, and the rebound taken by Kuzi. Kuzi's going to look ahead. 3, 2, 1. Krebs at the buzzer. It's short, and we are going to overtime as Fritz pulled down the rebound.
Yeah, I didn't like that possession. I like Tripp going to the basket. It's like they're working for, you know, they got to isolate Tripp and let him drive, and he's shooting a 3 from outside, and they were very fortunate. When they got the rebound, they could have threw it long. The center might have had a layup opportunity. So that was a good three-point shot by their good three-point shooter.
So overtime, we'll catch our breath here for just a moment. We'll keep our mic live here at the Spano Center so you can kind of feel the vibe. But 5 minutes back on the clock for the second time this season, the Tigers are headed to overtime. This time tied at 64 with the Gales, 64-64. 5 minutes on the clock. And again, enjoy the noise here at the Spano Center. All right, overtime here in Stockton tied at 64. St. Mary's and Pacific with 64 points each. The Tigers have not led since the 4:58 mark of the first half. And it's gonna be Shaquilo Fritz and Dan Fotu to jump it up in overtime. The Tigers overtime game was that triple overtime loss here to Boise State. That was back on November the 23rd, 82-76. The tip is up. It is controlled by St. Mary's. Teams stay in these directions. St. Mary's moving from our right to our left in overtime as Fotu receives it at the top of the key. Fotu feigns an entry, keeps it on the perimeter to Ford, who dribbles to his right, gives to his left to Krebs, who missed a shot to win it at the buzzer, takes this one and knocks it down.
He hasn't shot the ball well the second half. That one he knocked down.
Pierre Crockrell and Malik Fitz have fouled out. Crockrell for the Tigers, Fitz for the Gales. The Tigers move from our left to our right here in overtime. Jenkins dribbles to his right, takes it to the 10, tries to throw it up off the glass, and he got fouled. And he's going to the line. Danis Jenkins, for the third time this season, has scored in double figures. He has 10 points in this game and 3 of 4 from the line.
That was a great drive. Another guy fouled out for St. Mary's.
So Jenkins will shoot two.
Two shots.
First one is up and it is good. Jenkins now with 11 points. Second one is on its way here in a moment. It is up. It is good. Season high 12 points for Danis Jenkins, the true freshman tonight. 4:22 to go in OT. St. Mary's 67 and Pacific 66. Dribbling to his left is Kuzi. Kuzi hands to Ford. Ford, who had 16 points in the first half, has 23 for the game. This is going to be a two if it goes. It does not. I'm not sure who took that shot. Ford did, and the rebound is taken by Pacific. Price Noel is going to drive into the lane, scoop it off the window and in, and the Tigers, for the first time since the 4:58 mark in the first half, have the lead. It's 68-67 Pacific. What a comeback here for the Tigers. Kuzi driving into the left of the lane. Kuzi shot fake, gives it out to Ford. Ford on the right wing being stopped by Jenkins. Gives to his left to Kuzi. 14 on the shot clock. Kuzi step to his right, dribble to his left. Kuzi spins it back to his right in the lane. Puts a floater up over Fritz. It's around the rim and out. But he gets his own miss, and he puts it up reverse style and in.
How could the littlest guy on the court get the rebound, put it back up?
Kuzi got his own miss, and Shaquilo Fritz was the guy, the big presence that was right there and could not clamp the rebound. 69-68, St. Mary's by one. Danis Jenkins bounce pass to his left to Jabril Price-Noel. Price-Noel at the top of the circle. Price-Noel is going to dribble to his left. Jabril is going to feed Fritz across the lane, and he puts it off the glass. Stoudemire wanted a foul. I thought it was there too, but Fritz puts it up and in. I thought he got fouled too.
That's a good finish for being fouled right there.
I mean, Stoudemire was jumping up and down. 70-69 Pacific by one. Kuzi gives a bounce pass along the baseline to Jordan Ford, and he lays it up in at a back door there for Ford.
Both teams got some easy shots right there.
From our left to our right, Jabril Price-Noel, as these teams now leapfrogging each other for the lead. Price-Noel is clumsily dribbling and finally has it stolen by Alex Dukas. On ahead to Jordan Ford. Ford into the lane, weaves it back out, gives it to Kuzi on the right wing. Kuzi dribbles to his left. He's now at the top of the circle and backs it out. Gives on the left wing to Dukas. Dukas back up top to Kuzi. Kuzi in the high front court with 14 on the shot clock. St. Mary's 71, Pacific 70. Kuzi dribbling to his left. Toward the bucket, tries to scoop it up, and he's fouled by Jabril Price-Noel.
They're not handling double screen. They're sending a post guy to screen, then they're sending a perimeter guy to screen. That guy should switch out on the guard. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. They should switch the second screen, not the first screen, and help them recover. But they got to switch that second screen. The Tigers haven't made that adjustment.
Both teams are in the double bonus. Kuzi at the line, and his first free throw is up and good. Straight through that time for Kuzi, who's 6 of 6 from the line. He has 12 points. Second one is up and no good. It's a two-point game, and the rebound taken by Jaleel Tripp. St. Mary's 72, Pacific 70, 208 and counting to go in overtime. Up top, it's Vereen.
He's got to get Tripp back involved in the game. You know, he hasn't had a shot in the overtime or anything.
Well, here is Tripp, who has the handoff at the top of the circle.
This guy can't guard him.
Tripp going to drive him right to the lane, put it up and in. Kyle Bowen, the freshman from Perth, Australia, is in again. Fitz is out. This is Bowen's first minutes of the game. He had just checked in. Fifth double-double for Jaleel Tripp this season, by the way. Tripp, 28 points and 10 rebounds, career high in the points column. 72-72, ticking toward a minute and a half. Kuzi left of the lane, runs into Fritz. Kuzi gives a bounce pass down low to Bowen, and he puts it up and in.
What a great fake. What a great pass.
Well, Bowen, who had just been taken to the rack by Jaleel Tripp, is on the offensive end. The guy who gives the Gales a two-point lead and timeout called. It's got to be a full timeout, and again, we're going to keep it here. 30 stretches to a full with a minute 28 to go. St. Mary's 74 and Pacific 72. Let's check some scores around the West Coast Conference. Gonzaga defeats Pepperdine by 5, 75-70. So good effort for Pepperdine tonight. And the book on Pepperdine is they kind of play up or down to their competition. They're that kind of team, and they came ready to play to Spokane tonight, but a five-point loss for Pepperdine. 75-70, Gonzaga survives. How about Portland, a 76-65 win over San Francisco?
What a great win for Portland. They needed it. They've been struggling so much the last few years, and to get that win after battling Gonzaga so hard the other night, maybe that'll give them a little confidence when they go on the road.
Santa Clara over San Diego, 80-63. So if the Tigers win this game, they would be tied with Gonzaga at 2-0 in league. Just saying.
That's what you're trying to do. That's what you're trying to do.
BYU all over LMU today, 63-38. And we talked about how it was a tough spot for LMU going after they had to play on Thursday. BYU did not have to play on Thursday, so tonight was BYU's league opener, and they handle LMU 63-38. Here in overtime, 74-72, St. Mary's by 2. The Tigers have only led for... We're about to find out. 7 minutes and 9 seconds in this game. St. Mary's has led for nearly 31 minutes. And up until they had taken the lead in overtime, the Tigers had not led since it had been 20-18 back in the first half with 4:58 to go. So now you're down by 2. What are you drawing up here if you're Damon?
Well, I think obviously Tripp is the guy you want to go to. He should be scoring, shooting free throws, or creating the pass for a good shot. I don't see how anybody else shoots it beside him.
Again,
now, don't give him a stick. If he's wide open for a three, you know, Jenkins has a dribble and he's got a wide open 15-footer. Yeah, I think you got to put the ball in the hands of your best player.
Again, Pierre Crockrell has fouled out for Pacific. Malik Fitz has fouled out for St. Mary's. They fouled out in regulation. Tigers are out on the floor. It's Fritz, Chavichian, Jenkins, Vereen, and Tripp. It's going to be Ford, Kuzi, Alex Dukas, Tanner Krebs, and the true freshman Kyle Bowen, who did not see any minutes in regulation. Bowen, a true freshman from Perth, Australia, out there for the Gales. Vereen inbounds to Tripp, who takes it from our left to our right. Under a minute and a half to go in overtime, 74-72 St. Mary's. Javichian gives near midcourt to Vereen, who hands it back to Gary, dribbles toward the far sideline. Looking for a handoff, wasn't there, but now they get it in the hands of Tripp. Tripp at the top of the circle, going to start to drive, then pull it back, lob it down low to Fritz, who receives, and he misses the layup. Fritz received it, and in one motion tried to put it up over the cylinder, and he missed.
And that was a great pass, and you probably think that at least St. Mary's made somebody else try to beat him.
On the left wing, it's Dukas. Let's see if the Tigers come up with a stop now. 54 seconds to go in regulation. Tigers have come so close in recent years to beating the Gales here at home. Ford going to give it in the lane to Bowen, and Bowen backs his way into Gary Chavichian, and they're going to call foul on Chavichian.
You know why? Because he's inside on a help side defender. He's inside, and there was contact on the block. So that's a good call right here.
Or get another look. Yeah, he's in the restricted area. So Bowen is at the line again, the true freshman. Bowen is 3 of 6 this season from the line. Free throw is no good. So make it 3 of 7. This is a big spot here for the true freshman, who again is seeing his first minutes, literally, of this game. Randy Bennett going deeper in his bench than he's used to going. Second one is up and no good. He missed them both, and Fritz has the rebound. 44 seconds to go in regulation as a Tripp into the front court. Tripp moves to his left. Tripp is going to try and drive it in on Krebs. He does. He puts it up short, and they're going to call blocking foul on Tanner Krebs. Randy Bennett right now can't figure out how to contain Jahlil Tripp. Two shots coming. Krebs was there and trying to go step for step with him, and Krebs fell back hoping for a blocking foul and charge, and they called a blocking foul. Now Krebs is fouled out.
That is a tough call in the game of basketball, because you have a power player going in there and you're trying to guard him.
And what's the defender supposed to do?
Get out of his way?
Yeah.
Who's made? I used to always tell the refs, who's making the contact? If the defense is making the contact, call the foul. But if the offense is making the contact, it should be a no call.
So again, Krebs is fouled out. If there's ever a time that the Gales can be had, I mean, it's right now. They have Krebs out, they have Fitz out. They have
they just missed two free throws.
They have Bowen in there, a true freshman, and now in comes Elijah Thomas, redshirt junior from Peoria. And he is playing for the first time in this game.
I know he hasn't cracked a sweat this game so far.
Who's that, Thomas?
Thomas.
Yeah, no. So Tripp. First free throw is up and good. Jaleel with 29 points. And again, this is a career high for Jaleel. He's been building on it
this
since 24 points.
This one's a must-win make because you don't want to have to foul because there's only 36 seconds to go.
Fifth double-double of the season for Tripp. It's up, it's good. 74-74, 36.2 seconds to go
in the
game.
You don't want to foul the two guards for sure. Make everybody else beat them.
6.2 seconds difference shot clock.
They can probably foul any of those other guys. They probably won't make a free throw.
On the left side, it is Dukas. Dukas gives to Jordan Ford. 15 on the shot clock, tied at 74. Ford in the high front court near the midcourt stripe, guarded by Danis Jenkins, who's in his stance, bent at the knees. 8-7 to shoot. Now Ford's going to move to his left. Ford trying to navigate, find some room. He moves to his right. Ford drives, puts a runner up off the glass. It's no good. Rebound is loose, controlled by Vereen on the floor, and he wants a timeout. Either way, the Tigers have the possession arrow if it's a jump ball, and it is. But only 2.5 seconds to go.
They
and
did.
The Tigers will call a timeout.
Did a great job of using that clock. Because normally with 36 seconds to go, you think you'd have 8 seconds to go.
So timeout called by Pacific after the jump ball. So it's a 30-second timeout. So the Tigers have this on the alternating possession. 2.5 seconds to go. So you figure you're either winning this game or you're going to double overtime.
Well, you got to be careful that you don't try too much of a long trick play and throw the ball out of bounds or make a foul. You know, you got to be simple in what you do. I mean, you know, we're saying you want to go overtime, second overtime, because St. Mary's got some of their good players out of the game. And that should be a Pacific advantage.
So, I mean, if you got to go to double overtime, then so be it. But you want to make sure that St. Mary's does not get another possession here. So 2.5 seconds to go, and you figure you got to get, you know, it's enough time to get yourself to the three-point line at least.
Yeah, I mean.
They're going to inbound, I think, from. Is it going to be the far sideline in the backcourt, right? It's where the tie-up was, where they're going to inbound?
Well, you don't want to inbound in the backcourt. You want to have a play that you think they're going one way and go the other way.
Well, no, but I'm saying they're going to inbound.
Yeah, right over there. So if you could throw the ball, like maybe have a guy come to the half court, instead of going this way, go that way, and throw the ball inside and take two dribbles and get a shot on.
I mean, they're going to have to go about 80 feet here. From
yeah,
where
but
they're,
pass
where
the ball. The clock doesn't start until the ball's inbound.
Right.
You can throw the ball all the way down here if you want to.
It's got to be Tripp, Fritz, Chavichian.
If I was St. Mary's, Jenkins, I wouldn't even guard the backcourt. I wouldn't even guard the backcourt. See how St. Mary's is?
Yeah.
They're not even guarding the backcourt. They don't care if you get the ball back there.
Can Chavichian make a half-court shot? Inbound to Tripp. 2-1. He heaves from half-court. And, oh, it hit the front of the rim. Oh, is that close. Oh, boy.
I'd want to get a better shot than that, but you know what? That almost went in.
Oh, my goodness. Well,
here we go again.
Double overtime here at the Spano Center. So 5 more minutes back on the clock. And a double overtime coming up here from Stockton. Our score at the end of the first overtime, 74-74. We'll step aside, but again, we're going to leave the crowd here for you so you can kind of feel the atmosphere at the Spano Center, which has been jumping. And again, we'll set the stage for you when we catch our breaths here, but we'll leave the crowd on for you and enjoy it, and Coach T and I are back here in just a moment for double overtime in Stockton Pacific 74, St. Mary's 74. Overtime, double overtime in Stockton Pacific 74, St. Mary's 74. Zach Bayrudy, Coach Bob Thomason, so glad to have you with us. Checking on the numbers for the game, the Tigers are shooting 50%. St. Mary's is shooting 37% for the game. Look, the Pacific's played a great game. I also want to say this is a testament to how good St. Mary's is because they're shooting 37%. They're down a couple of their best players now, and here we are in double overtime.
Yeah, they've done a great job. They kind of faltered a little, but, you know, Fitz has been playing so good all year for them. I mean, he averages 16 a game, and he had a poor game tonight. So anytime you have a poor game, you have a chance to beat people. This is where Fritz needs to get up quick on this jump. There's no way he didn't get the ball.
Fritz is jumping with Kyle Bowen.
He needs to get up quick. He didn't get up quick on the overtime. He needs to get up quick. See, there he did.
And he got up quick, and the Tigers have the possession moving from our left to our right. 74-74 in double overtime as Javichian gives it near midcourt to Austin Vereen. Hands to Javichian, who dribbles toward the far sideline. Gary back to his right gives to Jahlil Tripp. Tripp, who has a career-high 30 points tonight. He's been a beast. Spins in the lane, goes up, and puts it in, but they're going to call a travel on Jahlil. Try to spin move in the
lane.
I'd
like to see that. They call spin moves when they...
I think he was fumbling the ball for a moment. He kind of gathered it back in, but they called it the travel on him. And now the Gales moving from our right to our left. 74-74. As up top, it is Bowen. Bowen will give it to Kuzi, dribbling to his right. Kuzi down right of the lane, leans into Chavichi and puts it up. No, they're going to call a foul.
Got a good angle on him.
But what did Gary do there? What did Chavichi do there?
I just don't think he had great position. So the offensive player just forced his way into a guy that didn't have good position. And they're going to call that. If you don't have good position when you're a defensive player, you're going to get called for the foul.
So Kuzi is at the line, and his first free throw is up and way short. So we are still tied at 74 here in double OT. Kuzi is 6 of 8 now from the line in this game. He has 12 points. Kuzi, the redshirt junior from Mesa, Arizona. Second one is up and good. So the Gales lead 75-74. From our left to our right, Jahlil Tripp. Again, 30 points, 10 rebounds, the fifth double-double this season for Jahlil Tripp. To Gary Chavichian. Chavichian to his left to Jenkins. Danis dribbles to his right. Danis down right of the lane, scoops it up and hit the bottom of the backboard, but Shaquilo Fritz there to clean it up and put it back up and in.
That's how he should play. Right around the basket, block shots, set screens, be quick.
Tigers leapfrog in front, 76-75. What a ball game this has been. Talk about bang for your buck if you're a fan here at this game. Kick to Elijah Thomas in the near corner for a three. It's an air ball.
You want him to shoot the ball.
Thomas is a 40% three-point shooter, but again, first minutes of the night. You absolutely want him to shoot the ball. I totally agree with you, but I mean, even still, he's 40%. As Chavichian's going to launch a three, that is way short.
And that one, good.
I didn't like that shot from
you
the near
go
wing.
Back to Tripp.
But Chavichian had a defender in front of him. He was from a good distance. As Ford weaving through the defense, and Ford's going to be fouled from behind.
If you foul these guys, especially the two guards, that's the only thing you have to do is don't foul the two guards in this overtime.
Again, both teams well into the double bonus here.
That was kind of a little hero shot by Gary. You know, just he knows, he believes he can make those shots, but come on now.
I mean, you can take those, like the shot clock's winding down. That's not a bad shot, but not
seconds. Yeah, you got to go through Tripp.
By the way, the foul is on Jenkins. That's his second. Ford's free throw is up and good. Ford has missed a free throw tonight. He is now 7 of 8 from the line. Second one is up and good. So St. Mary's leapfrogs ahead, 77-76. 3:30 and now counting to go in double overtime. Again, the Tigers lost a triple overtime game here a couple of months ago to Boise State. Vereen gives a bounce pass to his right, Shaquilo Fritz. Fritz is dribbling uncomfortably before he hands it off to Tripp, who dribbles to the near sideline. Tripp's going to drive it down right of the lane, put it off the window. No, it's short. Long rebound clamped by Gary Chavichian, though. He lobs it to Jenkins, and Jenkins able to tip it away from Ford and keep possession. 14 on the shot clock after the 20-second reset. Jenkins is on the right wing, off a screen, dribbles to his left, curls to the bucket, scoops it off the glass, and he missed the layup.
What a great drive. He just missed it. You know, what a great drive he made in there. He used quickness, he exploded.
He just got a bad bounce. He just got a bad
bounce. Player that does that, you know. He needs to learn how to lay it up a little softer, and that's all.
77-76, St. Mary's, as Ford has it on the left side, guarded by Jenkins. Jenkins is square to Ford. Ford trying to cross over, and he does. Puts it over Fritz, high off the glass and in.
Give him credit. Give him credit for that shot.
Jordan Ford had that crossover move that just juked Danis Jenkins out of his britches.
This is where Pacific needs to be patient. They have plenty of time. There's no reason to panic. Take a good shot.
79-76, St. Mary's. His trip has it at the top of the circle, ticking toward 2 minutes to go in double overtime. Tripp dribbling to his left. Tripp is going to drive it in, and he runs into Elijah Thomas, and they call him for a blocking foul. So Tripp back to the line. Again, he's working on a career high. It's not a broken record. I've said it so many times. 30 points for Jaleel Tripp.
You know
and
his
fifth double-double of the
trying
season.
Trying to block that shot on that drive by Ford. He was up so high.
Oh, Shaquille got way up there.
That ball
shot by Ford.
Way high.
Did you used to practice that shot, the kiss high off the glass?
No. I'd pass the ball.
Tripp's free throw is up and good. That's 31 now for Jaleel. Last player to score 30 or more points, Roberto Gallinat, 31 last year, February 23rd versus LMU. Tripp's junior college teammate, Roberto Gallinat from South Plains. The second one is up and good. So 32 points, that now belongs to Jaleel Tripp. 79-78 St. Mary's, ticking under 2 minutes to go in double overtime at the Spano Center in what's been an absolute pulse pounder here in Stockton. Ford on the left wing, spins toward the baseline, now spins it back out. Jenkins with good defense, gives it on the left wing to Kyle Bowen, the true freshman, up top to Kuzi, who drives right of the lane, scoops it off the window, no, but they're going to call a foul.
You know, it's weird.
The shot did not go. The foul is going to be on Gary Chavichian, a blocking foul.
It's amazing how they did. Their screen's coming, but he went away from the screen and still beat his man. See how he beat his man?
He got right on his back.
Good call.
So Kuzi at the line. He is 7 of 9 from the line in this game. First one is up and no good.
He's missed two. It's giving the Tigers a chance.
Second one is up, it's nearly an air ball. The rebound taken by Jaleel Tripp. So what an opportunity here for the Tigers, who trail by one. Tripp, our left to our right, into the front court. Tripp wants some space, now is trying to drive it in, goes right of the lane. Weird angle, tried to go off the window, and it just was not there. They wanted a foul, didn't get it.
Yeah, that was a tough shot, but you want to live and die with him doing those kind of things.
Ford is in the front court, 120 and counting to go in double overtime. 79-78 St. Mary's. Kuzi gives to his left to Dukas. Dukas gives to Ford. Ford is near midcourt. Ford dribbles to his left. Ford almost lost it, but gets it back. He's
Ford's
on the left angle. Seven to shoot. 6-5. Ford spins in the lane. Ford's going to take a fadeaway. It's partially blocked by Fritz. The ball is loose underneath the bucket, and last touch by St. Mary's. You're going to look at it, though. 59.3 seconds to go. The call on the floor, though, is important because they say out of bounds off of St. Mary's, meaning it's going to be Pacific ball unless you have irrefutable evidence. Yeah. So that's why the call on the floor is important. Let's see if we can get a look on. We have the monitor here, and we might see what the officials are going to look at. 79-78, St. Mary's by one, 59.3 seconds to go. I can't say enough about the effort tonight. Especially for Pacific, yes. Look, St. Mary's has not played the game that they normally play, where they shoot the ball very well. They don't ever have to go this deep into their bench. It's amazing to me that St. Mary's is still outpacing this game.
Yeah, they did lose their starting center, too, for the year, with ACL.
Yeah,
so that's
Matthias Tass. Yeah,
I talked to Randy before the game. They're making the adjustments through that, and they're hoping in the next couple of weeks they can figure out how the rotation and everybody will play out. But their guards have played well tonight. The St. Mary's guards have played well tonight. But, Tigers have played their hearts out. There's a couple of free throws they wish they probably would have had, a couple of shots they missed and they wouldn't have took. But other than that, it's been a great college basketball game tonight.
We're not seeing the replay. They're not showing us the replay on the television.
Come on.
They're not showing us the replay. This is the stadium crew. This is in the truck. This is not Michael January usually shows us the replay, but it's not Michael's camera crew tonight. It's the enhanced broadcast on stadium. So, if we're seeing what the viewers are seeing that are watching this game, they're not even showing any love. All right, the officials are going to huddle here. Sticking with Pacific basketball. All right, going back to Tripp, I'd imagine.
Well, yeah, but you want to get a good shot, obviously, or pass the ball to an open man. This is where you want to get two for one. You know what I mean? You've got 60 seconds to go. If you shoot too fast, St. Mary's can get a two for one, but you don't want to shoot too slow where it's inside 30 seconds. So you want to get two for one for sure here.
Trip into the front court, gives to Chavichi, and up top to Vereen. Vereen to Chavichi and dribbling to the far sideline. Hands it off to Tripp. 19 on the shot clock. Tripp is near midcourt. Tripp at the top of the circle. 14. Tripp's going to drive left of the lane this time. Go up, and he had the shot go off the bottom of the rim. He lost it.
Yeah. St. Mary's going to use the whole shot clock. I mean, they have to shoot the ball.
There's 10 seconds thereabouts difference, shot clock to game clock. So if you're the Tigers, you don't have to foul here. You want to play good defense as Danis Jenkins is guarding Jordan Ford. Obviously, St. Mary's wants to bleed as much time as possible.
Well, I don't want, you know, they still got a good shot.
7 to shoot, 16 on the game clock. Ford is on the left wing, spins it to his right. Ford looking to get to the left wing and now driving in, stumbling and putting it up at the buzzer. And in is Alex Dukas. What a circus shot that was. They're going to look at it. I don't know what the call is.
Basket's good, he said, I think.
So the call is that the basket's good again.
Can you believe he made that shot?
I can't believe he made that shot. Alex Dukas was stumbling over his dribble. Thought he was going to lose it, and he was falling down, and he flung it to the backboard, and it banked in. We're getting a look now on a replay, and it's a good shot, yeah. Yeah, he got it off, just barely.
Look at him. How did he get that shot off? He's all falling down.
I mean, he is tripping over Jaleel Tripp.
How did he make that shot, though? I mean, he's on balance. Golly.
So 8.7 seconds, all's not lost. I mean, you'd get 8.7 seconds, and now I'd imagine you want to run something if you can for Gary Chavichi. He's the guy you want shooting a three.
Well, I think Jenkins can make a three.
Or Danis.
You might want to bring, this is where they should take Fritz out. You know what I mean? They got to bring Noel in. Bring Noel in because he's made some threes.
Well, they're going to leave Fritz in. It's going to be Fritz, Tripp, Chavichi, and Vereen, and Jenkins.
Well, four of them can make it, but I would bring all five in that can make it. You know what I mean?
Tigers have to go. Plenty of time to go the length of four. They're going to put 9.2 on the clock, so they put time back on. 9.2. 81-78, St.
They
Mary's.
They might foul, too. St. Mary's might foul. I don't know. I doubt it. But
Fritz inbounds to Tripp. Our left to our right into the front court. 7-6. Tripp is on the right wing. 4-3, gives to Chavichian. Chavichian on the right wing with one. He's going to step back, take the three at the buzzer, and he banked it in! You've got to be kidding me! He banked it in off the square! Wow! That might be the hardest shot I've ever seen made, and he may have been fouled. They're going to check and make sure it's good, but I'm 90% to 100% that it's good. Gary Chavichian, the Armenian assassin, using the glass. And we're headed to triple overtime. That's a good shot.
That's good.
They could have called a foul.
You know, you're not going to call a foul unless you know for sure it's a foul. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I mean, you can't. Well, are they going to be 1-1 in triple overtime games this year?
Second triple overtime game the Tigers will play this season. Let's take a breath again. We'll keep our crowd on here at the Spano Center so you can feel the vibe. 81-81, thanks to Gary Chavichi, and a triple overtime is coming up next. courtside at the Spano Center. Zach Beirute, Coach T, Bob Thomason. Triple overtime.
We saw 81-81. Amazing shot. One by St. Mary's and one by the Tigers.
Alex Dukas made that ridiculous shot for St. Mary's to put him up three. Gary Chavichian banking in a three from the right wing to send it to triple overtime.
Is that why you fouled? Maybe Randy should foul, right? So they don't shoot three. I think you can live with that shot. That shot is not going to go in.
Wow. Shaquilo Fritz and Kyle Bowen again will tip it up. Fritz won this battle last time. The ball is up. It's controlled by Fritz, but it's going to go out of bounds on the St. Mary's bench, so Shaquilo got too much of it and bats it out of bounds.
I think Ford's going to have to do this whole thing by himself. That's a lot of pressure on him. I think Pacific, they just play smart. They're gonna get this one in this overtime right here.
St. Mary's from our right to our left here in triple overtime as Bowen gives it up top to Kuzi. Kuzi dribbles off a screen to his right. Kuzi penetrates, gives it to Bowen. Bowen in the lane. Bowen trying to work around Fritz, and he is, they're not gonna say travel. They're gonna say foul on Shaquilo Fritz. I thought he traveled.
Yeah, I don't know if he traveled, but I think you gotta call stuff that's for sure. You can't just catch touchy stuff now. Although this might not hurt the Tigers. The other players have a hard time with the line tonight.
This is Bowen. His free throw is up and around the rim and in, touching every part of the rim. It just seems like the Tigers in these overtime sessions, for some reason, can't get ahead. I mean, they're playing from behind. Once again, it's St. Mary's breaking the ice. Second one is no good for Bowen, and the rebound taken by Shaquilo Fritz. Now the Tigers have their first possession of triple overtime, moving from our left to our right. Again, Tigers' second triple overtime game this season. They've both been played at home. They lost to Boise State 82-76 on November 23rd in triple OT. Jenkins dribbling to his right on the right wing. Jenkins guarded by Ford. Danis is going to curl toward the baseline, put it up from the baseline right. It's no good. The rebound taken by Shaquilo Fritz, and he gets it back out to Jaleel Tripp. What a board.
Rebound.
Oh, my goodness. Shaquilo Fritz plays the game with a certain violence that is pleasurable to watch. Tripp driving in, Tripp with a step, puts it off the glass and in, and he gets fouled. And the foul is going to be on Kyle Bowen.
The times he's successful, he's getting all the way to the basket. The times he's had a hard time is when he's picked up the ball a little earlier and he's trying to reach in.
Tell you what, the best deal in stocks in California today, the best bang that you got for your buck is if you paid for a ticket to come to watch Jaleel Tripp play basketball tonight.
I'd hate to be the coach that has to replace him on the recruiting trails. Wow.
Tripp with 34, building on a career high. His free throw is up and good. So make it 35 for Jaleel Tripp. 84-82.
He's going to pass me. He's going to pass me.
What's your career high?
36.
Oh, he might.
Hope he does.
Elijah Thomas on the left wing gives it up top to Kuzi. Kuzi off a screen, dribbles to his right, right of the lane, slings it back out to Dukas, who takes a three, and it's off the mark. Rebound and tipped, and it is controlled by Jordan Ford. The Tigers could not quite get that board. And now Elijah Thomas on the left wing. Thomas gives a skip pass to Kuzi from the right wing. He drives, gives it out to Thomas. He's going to take a left wing three, and that is good.
And they fouled him.
And it's a chance at a four-point play. So count the basket.
And foul three-point shooters.
Foul is going to be on Vereen.
Two so far tonight. You know, you foul 2 3-point shooters. You give three free throws the first half and one here. That's why how you lose close games.
Foul's on Vereen. So Thomas is 0 of 1 from the line on the season. He has not attempted a free throw tonight. His free throw is no good, and the rebound taken by Shaquilo Fritz.
St. Mary's having a hard time from the line right now.
St. Mary's in this game is 22 of 32. 22 of 33 now for the game from the line as Tripp dribbles toward the near sideline. He's at the point now. Jaleel, they're sagging on him from the three-point arc.
They
he backpedals with
they
the dribble.
Should be down there. He should have five guys guarding him.
To Jenkins, who's on the left wing. Jenkins keeps the dribble, drives along the baseline. Jenkins trying to get closer. Takes a tough fadeaway over Ford. It's an air ball. And the miss is taken by St. Mary's Kyle Bowen. 3 minutes to go in triple overtime. St. Mary's 85, Pacific 84. For as hard as the Tigers have played, for as close as they've been, this would be an empty feeling if they don't come away with a win here tonight against St. Mary's.
played their hearts out tonight.
Kuzi dribbling to his right. Kuzi's going to curl toward the lane, and he traveled. Oh, no, they're going to call foul on Vereen. Looked like he traveled. Wow.
This is where the staff and coaches got to hold your poise. You're not going to change the call. All you need to worry about is getting that next play call.
Kuzi's free throw is up and good. Jaleel Tripp, by the way, quick note, second most points by a WCC player this season. Colby Ross with 38 at USC back on November the 19th. Second one is up and good for Tommy Kuzi, and the Gales have a three-point lead, 87-84 St. Mary's. Tripp to Javichian on the near side. Up top to Vereen with a ball fake before he hands Javichian going to the far side. Javichian hands it off to Tripp. Tripp is holding the ball by his knees, dribbles to his right. Now Tripp goes into the lane. Tripp goes up and gets fouled. He couldn't bank it in, but he got fouled. Clock stops with 2:27 to go. The foul is going to be on Elijah Thomas. Nobody else is in foul trouble here for St. Mary's. They had three players fouled out. Krebs, Fitz, and Fotu have all fouled out. For the Tigers, Crockrell fouled out at the end of regulation. Chavichian has four fouls, and Price Noel has four fouls. Free throw is up and good for Jaleel Tripp, who has now 36. And he'll pass Coach T's career high with this one.
I guarantee he had a lot more layups than I had during my 36.
Yeah, your outside game was what was on point. Second one is up, and no good, too strong, and a rebound taken by Kuzi. So it's a two-point game, 87-85, St. Mary's by two. 2:20 and counting to go in triple overtime here at the Spano Center. On the left wing, it's Thomas. Thomas will give it up top to Bowen. Bowen is going to dribble to his right and hand it off to Ford. Jordan Ford had 16 first-half points. He has 29 for the game. Ford takes a fadeaway from the right side. No good. The rebound taken by Gary Chavichian. To the near side to Tripp as we tick under 2 minutes to go in triple overtime. Tripp is on the near wing. Tigers trail by two. Tripp, you know he wants to drive. He's going to go in on Thomas, and they're going to call a charge on Jaleel Tripp.
That's a bad call. Stoudemire
is hot, and
that's
he better be careful because the Tigers, with this little time left,
that's
can't
a
afford a technical.
That is a bad,
it's a bad call.
That's a bad call. That's a bad call.
Thomas right didn't here, have right his feet here. Set. We're going to see on the replay. He didn't have his feet set. So 87-85, St. Mary's by two. We tick under 100 seconds to go in triple overtime. Kuzi from the left wing spins it back, gives it up top to Dukas. Dukas is going to give it to Ford, driving in the lane, scoops it up, and no good. The ball is loose. It's controlled by St. Mary's, gotten out by Bowen. It's going to be a three, and this is no good for Dukas, and the rebound taken by Vereen. I can't believe he shot it either. But the Tigers catch a break as Tripp is up top. Jaleel is going to drive it down the middle. Tripp is going to try and feed Jenkins, who had to receive it and to keep his feet in bounds. Gives Chavichian in the key, takes the shot, and knocks it down. You need a bucket? Call Gary Chavichian, the Armenian assassin. 87-87 with now a minute and under a minute to go in triple overtime. Spano Center has been a live wire tonight. Up top, it is Bowen. Bowen dribbling to the near side, gives to Kuzi. Kuzi fakes right, dribbles left, weaves through the defense. Kuzi with a ball fake, gives to Bowen underneath the cylinder, puts it up, no, but he gets fouled.
He probably should have made that shot. You know what I mean? He took his time extended. He could have made that shot. He really didn't get fouled that much.
Foul's going to be on Shaquilo Fritz, and that is the second on Shaquilo. Bowen, the good news is that he is not a good free throw shooter. He is one of four from the line in this game. Bowen, who did not play in regulation. Coming into this game, 3 of 6 from the line on the season. Free throw is up and good.
He makes that. He made that one like he can make them all.
Yeah. 88-87
St. Mary's, 43.6 seconds to go. Second one is up and good. So all of a sudden he found a stroke. 89-87 St. Mary's by two.
Hey, we've been here before.
We have been here before, but you don't want to repeat what happened before, because before the Tigers lost in triple overtime to Boise State. And again, we go back to the 23rd of November, 82-76, triple overtime. That was the game the Tigers came a fingernail away from winning in regulation. Jeremiah Bailey had the ball go just to keep touching his finger as he was laying it up.
But, you know,
and then they lost
down,
in triple overtime.
We've been down two several times. We've come in, tied it up, or hit a three, so... When was the last time you did a four overtime game?
I've never played one
or coached one.
Up until Boise State, I hadn't done a triple overtime game. So going four. 43.6 seconds to go. If you're Stoudemire, do you keep driving Jahlil Tripp? Do you try and maybe go to Chavichian because he's made the big shots when
he's you know what they're trying to do? You're trying to get Jahlil to drive with Gary in a space where his man can't help. And now you can go to the basket. But they're going to load up the box on Jahlil right now. I think they're going to load it up.
Okay, so if that's the case, are you comfortable going to Gary if they load up the box
on
Jahlil?
I don't think they're going to come off Gary. I think they're going to stick with Gary and load up the other four guys. So the question is, can Jenkins hit a shot, you know?
Again, there's plenty of time, so you got a two-for-one here.
St. Mary, well,
if you can go.
If St. Mary's wants what they want to do is not allow a three, but take 13 seconds off. So even if they score, then they're going to get the last shot.
Do you try for a two-for-one here if you're Damian? You can drive it in. I would like to.
Yeah, I think that'd be fun to get down here. But you don't want to panic and just take a shot. You know what I mean? It's got to be a good shot.
All right, Vereen, Chavichian, Tripp, Jenkins, and Hampshire on the floor for the Tigers. It is Bowen, Cousy, Dukas, Ford, and Thomas for St. Mary's. 43.6 seconds to go. Tigers trailing by two, 89-87 St. Mary's. Tripp from our left to our right across the Power Cat logo. Doesn't look like the Tigers want to go too quickly here as Tripp is at the top of the circle. Chest pass to Chavichian on the left wing. Rises up for three, and he got it! 90-89 Pacific by one with 31 and a half seconds to go. There's a fraction of a second difference, shot clock to game clock, and the Gales you think would want to hold for maybe the last shot is Ford's driving into the right elbow. Ford's going to drive it toward the baseline. He slips and falls, and they're going to call a foul.
That guy, yeah, he's called all tough calls on him.
Danis Jenkins with a blocking foul.
Don't get a technical here, though. You can't get a technical. Watch it. Oh, what a great shot.
I'd love to see. We're going to see the replay now. Jenkins was just going to the baseline. Yeah, that's a terrible call.
That was a bad call.
It's a terrible call.
He pushed off, if anything.
First one is up and good. Ford is an outstanding free throw shooter. 78% on the season. Ford now with 30 points. He has missed one tonight. He's 9 of 10 from the line. Second one is up and good. So with 16 seconds to go, it's a one-point game. And a timeout called by Pacific, a 30-second timeout. Well, now if you're the Tigers, you are down by one, but you have the trump card because you can hold for the last shot and maybe either win it at the buzzer, or you put a lot of pressure on their defense, especially with a guy like Jahlil Tripp. If you had Jahlil Tripp on your team right now, I mean, you would want to put pressure on the defense using him,
absolutely,
right?
And then Jenkins and Gary are going to have to spot up and be ready to catch the pass to shoot it, or the big guy might dump it off to him for a layup, but you're going to have to get to the basket. They just called a foul down here. You forced him to call a foul down here at that end.
All right, 16 seconds to go. Let's see if the Tigers have some magic.
That was a bad call.
Stoudemire is still very, very upset about that call. I mean, if he doesn't make that foul call, it's a turnover. And, you know, you get the ball back. He slipped and fell. He had nowhere to go. Anyways, Vereen will inbound to Tripp. Also, Chavichian, Jenkins, and Hampshire on the floor. Inbound to Jahlil, and he'll touch it near midcourt. Tripp our left to our right, into the front court. 13, 12, 11, 10. And away from the ball, there's a foul called on St. Mary's, and Chavichian's going to be shooting free throws. Foul's going to be on Alex Dukas. So 10.2 seconds to go, and you put Chavichian at the line.
You still got a guard, though.
Chavichian is a 68% free throw shooter. He's 19 of 28 this season from the line. He has not attempted a free throw in this game, but Gary Chavichian obviously had
that. Seems like they want to get Fritz back in the game for Hampshire to play a little defense and be quicker.
First one is up and no good. Second one is up. It's a tie. It's good. Shaquilo Fritz will check in for James Hampshire. So 91-91, 10.2 seconds to go.
I got to believe Ford is going to take this shot.
Well, the Spano Center is on its feet. St. Mary's is going to get Christers Zorkas. Remember Christers Zorkas? He hadn't been in forever.
Well, he had a three, though, in the first
half.
Yeah.
So Elijah Thomas checks out. So it's Zorkas, Ford, Kuzi, Bowen, and Dukas for St. Mary's. Ford in the front court. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Ford is at the free throw line, dumps it down low, and it's a dunk that was blocked. No foul, no goaltend, and we're going to four overtimes. Quadruple overtime here at the Spano Center. The officials are now talking about something. They got it down low to Dukas for a dunk, and it was blocked. I'd love to see a replay. Randy wants him to look at something. I don't know if we're going to four overtimes. The Gales want the officials to look at a replay.
Oh, I see what he's trying to say. Zizekian is hitting the net when he comes over, that he is hitting the net. See, inside the net.
Nope, they're not gonna review anything.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, but it was with like a fraction of a second and it was from underneath. So let's go to quadruple overtime here at the Spano Center. Yeah, we'll keep our crowd noise on, catch our breaths, and fourth overtime coming up in just a moment. It's 91-91 here in Stockton. Coach T, you got a fourth overtime in you?
Hey, it's easy on me. Part of the player.
Zach Beirutti, Coach Thomason, so glad to have you with us for quadruple overtime. Pacific and St. Mary's here at the Spano Center. And it's Shaquilo Fritz and Kyle Bowen to jump it up at center court. Fritz, Chavichian, Tripp, Vereen, and Jenkins on the floor for the Tigers. Bowen, Elijah Thomas, Jordan Ford, Tommy Kuzi, and Alex Dukas on the floor for St. Mary's. The Tigers win the tip and move from our left to our right as they have since the second half in quadruple overtime. 91-91, And a Tripp gives it to Chavichian inside the left wing. Chavichian is going to dribble near midcourt and give to Jahlil. 10 seconds to shoot. Tripp is at the top of the circle with 8, now 7, 6, and now 5. Tripp drives into the key, takes it, and it's off the mark, and the long rebound pops out to Kuzi.
See, when he does that, St. Mary's wins that battle. You know, he's got to go earlier and put the ball on the floor and create stuff.
Gale's moving from our right to our left in quadruple overtime as Kuzi fumbles a handoff at the top of the circle but gets it back, now moving toward the left wing. Kuzi guarded by Vereen, slips toward the baseline left, gives it out to Bowen. Bowen dribbles to his right near the right elbow, hands it off to Ford, curling to his left. Ford, between the legs dribble with Ford to shoot, launches it over Jenkins, and it's too strong. Long rebound pops out, and Jenkins able to track it down. Good board there on a tricky opportunity for Danis Jenkins. Jenkins in the front court on the right wing. Jenkins dribbles to his left. Jenkins will give it to Jahlil Tripp. Tripp is calling for a screen, and at 13 seconds on the shot clock, 12, 11, and now 10 as he gives to Chavichian on the right wing. Gary guarded tightly by Kuzi, gives it back to Tripp. 6 and now 5, they gotta go. 4 to shoot and now 3. Tripp's gonna take a step back straight away. 3 and he banked it in! Just the second 3 that Jahlil Tripp has made all season.
You know, it's great, but that's lucky. And so maybe tonight you can win lucky, but that's not a good shot.
No, but you needed something, and they got more than something. They got a 3 from Tripp to take a 3-point lead, 94-91. His Kuzi shot is blocked by Vereen. Loose ball gotten back in by St. Mary's, and it's go out of bounds, last touch by Pacific. Tigers had a chance for the block and the loose ball. This is the most overtimes in an NCAA game this season, by the way. Just FYI. Timeout called by St. Mary's. It's going to stretch to a full timeout. Let's take it as well. And again, we'll let you hear the Spano Center. Instead of going to break, it's just fun to hear the atmosphere. 3:08 to go. Coach Thomason and I will take a breather, but again, enjoy the noise here in Stockton. Pacific 94, St. Mary's 91 in quadruple overtime on Fox Sports AM 1280. All right, 3:08 to go in quadruple overtime, the most overtimes in an NCAA game this season here in Stockton, California tonight as we tick toward the 10 o'clock hour Pacific time. Baseline right, Jordan Ford will inbound, and Ford will inbound to Kyle Bowen, baseline right. He gives it back to Ford, who gives it out to Thomas, now on the left wing to Kuzi. Kuzi is going to dribble to his right, curl into the lane, put a floater up, and it's short, and the rebound taken by Austin Vereen. The Tigers' largest lead in this game is 3, which is where they are now. So another bucket here, and the Tigers are on their largest lead of the night. Vereen in the high front court. Vereen looking for somewhere to go, gives to Jenkins, who popped loose. Jenkins dribbles to the right wing. Jenkins crosses over into the lane. Jenkins a running shot, and it's no good. Rebound tipped and controlled by nobody, but it's going to be a loose ball foul on St. Mary's. It's going to be on Alex Dukas.
Good call right there.
By the way, Jahlil Tripp, 39 points tonight for the Tigers as Alex Crook keeps the numbers coming. That is now the most points scored by a player in a game this season for a West Coast Conference player, passing Colby Ross, who had 38 at USC back in November. Free throw is up and good for Danis. That is the largest lead now of the night for Pacific. The most games, most points scored in the game, by the way, 44. Bill Stricker down on press row with us right now. December 21st, 1968 versus Portland. We saw Gallinat score, I think, 42 versus USF a couple of years ago. Is it 41? Second one is up and good for Danis Jenkins. 5-point lead for the Tigers, 2.5 minutes to go. And if you're at the Spano Center now, you got to be on your feet. The noise
you gotta
is coming.
You got to foul the two guard. You cannot foul the two guard.
So here comes the Spano Center to life again. Cousy dribbling to the left elbow. Gives it out to Bowen. And Bowen goes, rather that was Dukas going into the lane. And he's going to be fouled by Jaleel Tripp, an armbar. It was 44, Dukas, not 14, Bowen with the ball. '96-'91 Pacific. And did Tripp just foul out? He did. So Tripp is fouled out, and Tripp in quadruple overtime.
Why was that foul on Tripp? I thought it was on Vereen. I thought Vereen was taking the charge. You're a fucking man, aren't you?
And Jaleel Tripp. 39 points, 11 rebounds. A career high, and 5 points away from matching Bill Stricker's program record. So Alex Dukas is going to the line again. Both teams have been in the double bonus since Moses is wearing short pants. Free throws up and no good for Dukas. Second one is up and good. So 96-92, Pacific by four. So Jabril Price-Noel is in for Tripp, who has fouled out. He and Crockrell are the two that have fouled out for the Tigers. Crockrell fouled out in regulation. Javichian has it, gives it up top to Danis Jenkins. Jenkins dribbles to his right, penetrates, puts up a wild runner. It's no good, but Hampshire trying for the loose ball, and they say out of bounds. I thought St. Mary's was last to touch it. They're going to say last touch by Hampshire. Not a good shot there by Jenkins. No. That was a wild shot.
Instead of being running, jumping, just back the dribble up, take a little jumper he wants to take. That was bad, yeah. That was bad possession right there.
Quadruple overtime here at the Spano Center. Pacific 96, St. Mary's 92.
Use the whole shot clock and didn't shoot, it'd be better than that.
You know, it feels like now the Tigers without Tripp, as we tick under 2 minutes to go, are going to have to like survive this without Jaleel out there. Up top, it is Dukas. Fake right, dribble left, goes to the bucket, puts it off the window
and
in.
That's an unbelievable shot.
That's a great shot by Dukas. And timeout called by Randy Bennett. So a 30-second timeout called by St. Mary's. Okay, so now my question to you is, how do you compensate for the loss of a guy that had put you on his back all game? I mean, you have a ton of time left here, minute 51 seconds. It was nice to have Jaleel's presence there. You knew he could drive it for you.
Don't foul out. That's what you tell him. Don't be trying to take a charge at the end of the game.
I mean, look, we're in quadruple
right now, what you have to do is you have to share the ball. I mean, you got Jenkins. Gary can make shots. Noel. But they're going to have to come together and really pass them on. But the whole key is take good shots. I mean, St. Mary's didn't force him to take that last shot. You know, he did that,
yeah.
And that's what you have to make sure you have enough points.
Take good shots.
You take the shot you can take, you know.
All right, it's and I'll tell you what, Sotomayor right now is trying to bestow as much confidence as he can on Jabril Price-Noel, who has had to come off the bench here.
He's played well tonight.
He has.
I mean, but then he didn't play a lot down the stretch because he went with the five guys they should have gone with.
So it's Vereen, Chavichian, Price-Noel, Hampshire, and Jenkins on the floor. It's Chavichian in the front court, dribbling toward the right wing. Give it up top to Vereen. Vereen, chest pass to the far side to Danis Jenkins. Jenkins gives it up top to Price-Noel. 14 on the shot clock, ticking toward a minute and a half to go in quadruple overtime. Price-Noel is on the right wing, cuts it back to his left. Price-Noel goes left of the lane, scoops it off the glass. No, but he does get fouled. That was a great drive, and he nearly finished.
What's so good about that is that you use the shot clock and you're getting two free throws.
So a minute 26 to go in regulation.
I mean, both teams can look at free throws St. Mary's missed, opportunities, banking shots the Pacific made. Free throws missed. Both teams can look at it like, well, they could have won the game. Now it's find out who's going to do it.
Price Noel's first free throw
back
is
rim,
no good. Again, no, 1:26 to go, not in regulation, but in quadruple overtime.
Yeah,
the overtimes have kind of melded into like a second regulation for us. So this will be like another 20 minutes once we're done with quadruple overtime. Second one is up and good for Jabril. So Finstoon now will check in, get some fresh legs out there. Finstoon checks in for Jabril Price Noel. 97-94 Pacific by three.
Player something where they take him out. 6'7", he wants rebounding out there and athletic ability.
1:24 and counting to go in quadruple overtime. Kuzi has it up top, dribbles to his left. Kuzi, a ball fake, left of the lane, gives it out to Dukas. Dukas in the hands of Jordan Ford. Ford explodes toward the baseline. Ford trying to go into Javici and missed the shot. And Danis Jenkins cradling the loose ball. And they're going to call a foul on St. Mary's.
Oh, that's a bad foul, St. Mary's.
Jordan Ford picks up the personal.
Because now you got a good free throw shooter. Jenkins going to the free throw line.
It's the first foul on Jordan Ford. Great job being strong with the basketball, Danis Jenkins.
He looked like he was
great block by Javician.
And well, he went for the block, but he kind of stayed out of his way. He might have got a piece of it because he thought he was going to get fouled.
Danis Jenkins has 14 points. He's 7 of 8 from the line in this game. First one is up and good. Makes it a 4-point game. 98-94. The Tigers can match their largest lead of the night if Jenkins makes this free throw. Second one is up and good. It rattles in. 99-94 Pacific. A minute 10 to go in the fourth overtime. From our right to our left, it is Kuzi into the front court. Kuzi drives toward the baseline, puts a floater up off the glass. He missed it. Hampshire trying for the rebound, but it's out of bounds. They say last touch by St. Mary's. They're going to review it. I thought it was clearly off of Hampshire. So did Sotomayor. He was lamenting it. But they're going to go to the monitor. And we'll see. Maybe they had it right.
You know, the worst part
about
it is
get a look at our monitor.
We made a couple tough calls tonight. And if you didn't have replays like when I coached like that, that'd be off. Yeah.
Let's see. So Hampshire definitely had the position.
But it looked like it went off.
He was.
But the other guy hit it from behind.
Yeah, it was.
You gotta get that ball though. You gotta get up there and be strong with that ball.
It is gonna go back to St. Mary's. The last time Pacific scored 100 or more points, by the way, December 3rd, 2017, against Division II Arkansas Fort Smith. The Tigers scored 105 points in that particular game. So we are anticipating that they are going to say it's St. Mary's ball. If that is the case, it should be a 20-second reset if that's the case. They got to check the shot clock. 99-94 Pacific by 5 with 1:01 to go in quadruple overtime. This is the longest game in NCAA basketball this year. Everything else has long gone final, right? We gave you the out-of-town scores. Portland defeating San Francisco 76-65. Great win for Portland. Pepperdine almost did it up at Gonzaga. But the number one team in the country, the Zags, a 75-70 win. BYU 63, LMU 38. And Santa Clara puts San Diego in an early hole in league. San Diego 0-2 as Santa Clara wins 80-63. They're going to go St. Mary's ball as we anticipated. Should be at 20 seconds on the shot clock now, right? Yeah, 20 seconds on the shot clock. So baseline left, Kuzi will inbound. A minute 2 to go in quadruple overtime. Baseline left, Kuzi looking to inbound. Looking, inbounds to Ford in the near corner. Ford spins the dribble to his right, gives to Bowen. Bowen trying to drive it in and had the ball knocked away. Last touch by Pacific, 16 on the shot clock. 57.1 to go in quadruple overtime.
Austin, don't run in.
Baseline right, Kuzi will inbound. Vereen is guarding the inbounder, Kuzi. Doing jumping jacks, and Kuzi wants a timeout. Tiger bench wanted the 5 seconds. So St. Mary's gets the timeout before a 5 second violation. Great out of bounds defense there by Pacific.
That might be their last timeout. You know, so
I was going to see. You get one per overtime.
I know,
right?
This is the second one they've run this overtime. So. And if it is, that'll affect the game because you know you need timeouts in the last 20 seconds of this game.
So 57.1 to go in this overtime, the quadruple overtime.
St. Mary's 16 on the shot clock. Isn't a pressing team, so if they score here, I don't know if they'll throw press on the Tigers or not, but they have never been a real pressing team.
Finn Stoon, Chavichi, and Hampshire Jenkins, and Vereen for Pacific. Kuzi, Zorix, Krister Zorix is back out there. Dukas, Bowen, and Ford for St. Mary's. Jordan Ford, perhaps the best player in the conference, inbounding baseline right. Inbounds to Bowen, who hands it back to Ford. Curling to his left, Ford curls in and gets blocked by James Hampshire on a scoop attempt. Finstoon has the loose ball, gives to Jenkins.
Bring it back out.
Takes it into the front court, and now Jenkins and the Tigers can bleed some time. Jenkins is going to be fouled on a reach-in by Jordan Ford.
That's the last guy you want to foul.
And now the Tigers can maybe start to taste it a little bit. 43 seconds to go in quadruple overtime. It's 99-94 Pacific, and a great free throw shooter, as Coach T just mentioned, and Danis Jenkins is headed to the line.
I wouldn't want anybody else at the line out there.
No, he's the guy.
I would put two guys rebound on the first one. Make it look familiar with your shirt, you know what I'm saying? Then I take them off the line.
Tigers have vacated the lane. The first free throw, though, is up and good, did not affect him. So for the first time since 2017, the Tigers have notched 100 points in a game. Second one for Danis is up and good. 101-94, 7-point lead with 43 seconds to go. From our right to our left, Jordan Ford will take it across the PowerCat logo. 36 seconds to go in quadruple OT. He launches a three and knocks it down.
Oh, Randy got it.
And a timeout called by St. Mary's. I guess they had another timeout in their pocket. 30-second timeout. I'm not sure how the timeouts
don't
work
you hate
in overtime.
Three. That's my time going. At least you're 4 points up right now.
So 34.1 seconds to go. It's a 4.1 second difference, shot clock to game clock. We're gonna check the timeout situation here.
That's why, you know, Damon was trying to call a timeout. I always waited a second to see if the other team wanted to call a timeout, because you want to use their timeout, not yours. If you get in a pickle here, you want to make sure you have another timeout. I think he has two.
I think so, because St. Mary's obviously. CP, what's the timeout situation? They have zero, and Pacific has two. Okay. Okay, so Damon did want to call. He did try and call a
That's
timeout,
why
but they
wait,
got Randy's.
You got to wait a second to see if they.
So 34.1 seconds to go. It's a 4-point Pacific lead, 101-97. Got to be strong with the basketball here if you're the Tigers.
And call a timeout if you get in the jam.
You're right there, Gary. Come on, man. Here.
It's going to be Vereen to inbound. Also, Price Noel, Finstoon, Jenkins, and Chavichian on the floor for the Tigers. In my entire broadcasting career, this has been maybe the most memorable game I've ever called. This has been one hell of a basketball game tonight at Stockton. Has everything you could have wanted. Baseline left, Vereen running the end line, inbounds to Price Noel. Jabril gives it in the middle of the floor to Jenkins, who takes it into the front court, and then he's fouled. So they got it to Jenkins, the guy they want taking free throws. Couldn't have done it better. So now there's the shot clock and the game clock are going to be in step. There's 3/10 of a second difference, shot clock to game clock.
Well, this is where I know when we were playing, I would jam press with our zone press because make them take their time coming up the court. But also I would get extended zone because what you don't want them to do is make a three. They cut the three if they make these two free throws.
Danis's first one is up and good. It rattled in.
If they score two, you're still up four. You know what I mean? And that's a good sign with the ball up four.
Jenkins with 19 points and 8 rebounds. Second one for Danis is up and good. It bounced in off the front of the rim. 103-97 Pacific. Ford touches the ball, moving from our right to our left. Ford across the center court stripe. Again, the shot clock and game clock are, for the most part, in step. Ford launches a desperation three from the right side.
That's
no good.
Right there.
Bryce Noel with the rebound, and he is fouled from behind by Krister Zorkas. And now you can taste it, and so does the Spano Center as the crowd rises as one. 19.7 seconds to go. And the Tigers leading 103-97. And Jabril Price-Noel headed to the line. He has 13 points. He's 3 of 4 from the line in this game. Free throw number one is up and good. Jacques Perry is going to check back in for St. Mary's. He takes over for Kyle Bowen. In quadruple overtime, the Pacific Tigers find themselves on the brink of knocking off the St. Mary's Gales. Preseason top 25, St. Mary's Gales. Second one is up and good. 105-97 Pacific with 19.7 seconds left to survive as Ford takes it our right to our left into the front court. They'll let him have a layup, and he puts a finger roll up and in with 15 seconds to go. 105-99 Pacific by 6. Vereen is going to inbound to Chavichian, and he is going to be fouled by Dukas in the back.
You know, Vereen was taking his time inbound the ball, but the referee was already counting. So you got to make sure that you're in tune with the referee, because just because you haven't picked up the ball doesn't mean he's been counting.
Let's go, shooter. Let's go, shooter.
Tigers huddled for a quick moment on the near side. Chavichian's going to the line. 14.4 to go.
Yeah, I think given that 2 point, you'd like to get a little more time off, but that's good basketball right there. You don't want to give him a three.
Free throws up and good for Gary. Chavichian, was it the second overtime where
he
banked
that
three in?
I don't know, but if he didn't make that shot, they lose.
Chavichian had a wild shot off the glass, I think, to send it to triple overtime. Second one is up and no good.
Terrible.
He clanged it. And a rebound taken by St. Mary's. 106-99 Pacific, 10 seconds to go. Jacques Perry is going to hand it off. Gale's taking too much time. Dukas is going to take a desperation three. It's no good. Rebound is loose, controlled by Chavichian. He is fouled with 1.6 to go.
You know, that's the first really good team the Tigers have played all year. Now, I'm not saying boys are not pretty good. It's a really good team, and then they responded with the win, you know. Without Moore, too, you know. Without Moore.
Without Justin Moore.
Yeah.
And with Jahlil Tripp having fouled out in this last overtime. Free throw is up and no good for Chavichian, who wanted another one.
He wanted to move back right in front of the three-point line on his free throw.
Yeah, he'd probably be better suited taking it at the three-point line.
He's shooting a little flat. He needs to push up right with that front rim.
Second one is up and good. 107-99 Pacific, 1.6 seconds. The inbound, the horn, and the upset. The Pacific Tigers defeat the St. Mary's Gales, and they take them down in Stockton tonight in four overtimes. 107-99.
What a great game.
Oh, man. This is in a season that's featured a couple of, I think, signature wins in Damon Stoudemire's tenure. This is right at the top of that list.
Absolutely. I mean, this is a big one. Start a league. I thought the Pepperdine game really set the stage for this one. If they don't come back in that game, it's been tougher tonight. If they win this game, now that they have a week off, they can work on their injuries, get back, get focused, and they got USF coming in next week. And USF's 0-2, so it's going to be a big game there.
I'll tell you what, if you're ever going to have a week off, which the Tigers do now, how about after a quadruple overtime game, you get a week off? I mean, that is a big...
I don't know. They might want to play tomorrow. You know what I mean?
They'll still be
floating tomorrow. Fly Gonzaga down there. Let's play tomorrow.
They'll still be floating tomorrow. Our final score in four overtimes at the Alex G. Spano Center. The Pacific Tigers 107, the St. Mary's Gales 99. Pacific Courtside Live, long overdue, but it's going to be a great addition to Pacific Courtside Live. We'll talk with our City of Stockton human resources hardworking player of the game, Jahlil Tripp, who had 39 points. And we'll also talk with Damon Stoudemire, who I'm sure is going to be a happy and exhausted man. Our final score tonight, the Pacific Tigers 107, the St. Mary's Gales 99 in four overtimes. And Stockton Pacific Courtside Live is coming up next.